until I can get my satisfaction.
Oh, is that on? Oh, it is. Why did that look like it wasn't on? I'm just gonna dream until I can get my satisfaction. Joe, my Peach Ring G Fuel is an hour away. I gotta wait for tomorrow for delivery. Oh, is it like, are they done working? So now you just have to wait literally for tomorrow? Oh, you're saying it's an hour away, like an hour drive. I thought you were saying it'll be delivered in an hour. What song should I play? Dude, I'm live early as fuck. I am never live this early. Nah, not Kingston Town. It's not a reggae vibe today. Sorry for party rocking. Or is it a Halloween vibe, dude? It's a Halloween vibe. This is Halloween. Need to play that. While we wait menacingly for the notification to go out. Somebody just said late. Brother, I am live 45 minutes fucking early. You need a haircut? You don't think I know that? I'm getting one Wednesday. To see something strange, come with us and you will see. This our town of Halloween. This is Halloween. This is Halloween. Pumpkins scream in the dead of night. This is Halloween. Everybody make a scene. Trick or treat. Tell the neighbors come and die. Do y'all fuck with that movie though? For the pre-noty people? I don't know if I fuck with that movie. Every time I watch Nightmare Before Christmas, it's like, I'm like, every time I watch Nightmare Before Christmas, I'm sitting there, and I'm like, this movie's gonna be a fucking banger. I used to love this movie. I'm gonna love this movie. And then it's mid. But then the next year, I do the same thing over and over again. The next year, I queue up Nightmare Before Christmas. I'm like, this is gonna be a fucking banger. And it never is. It never is. But I always think that it's gonna be a banger. Hello, everybody flooding it. How is everybody doing on this fine goddamn Friday? I am live early as shit. You might be asking yourself, Joe, you're live 45 minutes early. What's going on, man? And to answer your question, I'm going to a haunted house later, and I have a scheduled time that I have to be there. And if I streamed at my regular time, I would be late. So I'm live early so I can go to a haunted house. Big dubs. Big dubs for making both work for the Bartman. Whalen for the sub, Joshy for the sub, Wub for the sub, and Massid for the sub. It's Halloween season, bitch. I'm getting ready. I don't know. Chat. Do I dress up as Batman for Halloween and call myself the Bartman?
I am the Bartman.
What are Batman lines? Somebody give me a Batman line to say. Somebody give me a Batman line. I would get a less cringe costume than this. What are Batman's most famous quotes? Batman's most famous quotes.
I am the Bartman. The night is darkest just before the dawn.
Dude, I would feel like such a loser doing that.
I am the Bartman.
React to iShow speed. Settle down, buddy. The fuck am I going to do? Just sit there and watch him? What am I going to say? I'm a commentary react guy. I'm just going to sit there and say, that's funny. Like,
Like, people, you gotta realize, when you recommend a video for me to react to, whether it's on stream or in the Discord video suggestion tab, it has to be something that I can commentate on. If you're just recommending me Funny Vine Compilation 37, that's such a shitty fucking react video, okay? This isn't 2015. I'm not gonna sit there and just go, no, that one wasn't funny. Like, I'm gonna say, I say stuff, right? Barbecue boy for the Thridge Bets. Anything but Jeffrey Dahmer. I'm not going to dress up as Jeffrey fucking Dahmer. If that's the most popular male Halloween costume, I will be shocked if people dress up as fucking Jeffrey Dahmer. Ballistic for the subcamp for the Thridge Bets. Have you watched the Jeffrey Dahmer documentary? No, I haven't. Wait, the documentary, maybe. The show, no. Crippy for the sub. Razors for the sub. Wubblosy for the sub. I already said that. We have some banger-ass reactions today, chat. Starting off. Scientists successfully teach gorilla it will die someday. Kid completes 100 airs in 24 hours. This is a Darman video. We have a Channel 5 Andrew Callahan video. This may or may not be watchable, okay? I pre-scanned this video, and, like, this guy's drinking his own piss in this. So I don't know what the terminology of TOS is in terms of whether or not that's watchable. Then we move on. We have banned GameStop training video. Bill Nye goes sneaker shopping. That's going to be a fucking banger. And then a Gunner TV video. OnlyFans pimps are delusional. Why would you teach it that? Why would I teach what that? A gorilla that it's going to die someday? This may or may not be a fake video. Tool and Universe. This is definitely fake. It's The Onion. Okay. If you see The Onion, that's probably... That is probably a fake video. Tool and University researchers say Quigley is now able to experience the crippling fear of impending death, previously only accessible to humans. Let's give it a watch.
Scientists at Tulane University's Primate Research Center announced they have taught a gorilla that someday it will die. Nate Meredith has more in the lab report.
Dude, imagine you have to fucking sign language to a gorilla. You're going to fucking die. Like, how do you teach it that?
Thanks, Dan. In an historic first, a team of primatologists has succeeded in teaching Quigley, a western lowland gorilla, the concept of mortality and his inevitable doom. Lana Burrows and Philip Townsend are the researchers leading the project.
When we first started with Quigley, he was just a normal, happy ape, not a care in the world.
Well, the first thing we did was we taught him patterns like red block, blue block, green block, over and over. Then it became
Why does this look so real, though? Is this not fake? It's The Onion, but, like, this looks like, how do they get these people?
Pattern of gorilla born, gorilla grow, gorilla die, over and over.
Right.
The research.
Oh, my God! Bro, they showed him that? No, that's not real. This is not a real video. I already said this was not a real video going into it. I'm not going to fall into the trap. There's no shot they showed a gorilla, a picture of a dead gorilla, and then just kept fucking repeating that.
Researchers then showed Quigley photographs of dead and dying gorillas while communicating the phrases "you someday" and "no choice."
It took thousands.
You someday, dude. Imagine trying to teach a human that they're gonna die one day. You show them just pictures of dying, like, old people. That's gonna be you.
But Quigley finally became cognizant of the correlation between himself and the decomposing pile of hair and flesh in the photo.
Quigley shared his feelings in a confessional after completing each exercise.
Muscles mine will rot away.
Quigley also began painting pictures like these almost every day. To make sure Quigley retains the awareness of his own demise, the team spends several hours per day reinforcing the certainty of death's arrival.
Quigley, you die. You...
Bro, but is that like a green screen or is she actually with the gorilla?
You will die.
Bro. Dude, that's, like, so depressing to, like, read, to, like, establish every day to a gorilla that they're gonna fucking die.
Soon.
The researchers say at first Quigley could only communicate rudimentary fears about his own death. But he soon moved on to expressing more complex emotions, like indifference and self-hatred.
Stupid Quigley now sees truth. Existence, cruel joke.
And just 2 days ago.
There's no fucking shot. There's no shot. That's not, there's no shot a gorilla would say existence is a cruel joke. That's literally some human type shit.
Philip Townsend and his colleagues even witnessed what they believe to have been a panic attack in Quigley.
He was letting out these anguished cries and banging his head against the wall, and I just thought, we did it.
The Tulane scientists...
We did it. We successfully made a gorilla depressed in the acknowledgement that he is going to die.
Believe that we may be able to teach a gorilla to resort to alcoholism or even try to kill itself in as little as a decade. The scientists next plan to test whether the results with Quigley can be replicated with other species. They are in the initial stages of teaching bunny rabbits that they will all die.
Okay, that's fake. Okay, now that right there made that shit fake. They're going to teach you, you're going to teach a bunny.
You will both die.
These are thrilling times. For the lab report, I'm Nate Meredith.
Now I kind of want to teach. Do you think I could teach my dog that she'll die? Do you think I could convey to my dog the grasp of morality or of mortality? If I spent like 2 years, come on, chat. I spend 2 years every day. 2 years every day trying to kill. I understand you're saying, oh, there's the limits of the brain, but I spend two years every day somehow conveying to Daisy that she is going to die. You don't think my dog would at all grasp that? Don't do it. And dude, it wouldn't work. It wouldn't. And what? Okay, so you're saying ignorance is bliss. You're saying that if an animal could be taught that it's going to die, don't teach it that it's going to die.
Thanks, Nate. Scientists in Britain.
And then it just mopes. You teach all these species of animals that they're going to die, and they all just become immediately depressed.
Conducting a similar study, teaching a mouse with a human ear grafted to its back what a freak it is.
What? Okay, yep, there we go. There's the onion for you. There's the onion for you. That was 20 fucking 10. All right, that was just a little funny video to start off the day. Scoops for the sub. Prez for the 900 bits. Shakespeare for the 300 bits. It's been a while since I've been here. Been so far busy with a first year at college, taking math, physics, and politics. How's life going? Life's going. You know, I wake up every day, I look in the mirror, and I say, well, I'm not dead yet. Another day, another dollar. That's what I say. That's what I... You know, and you're going to say that's a bit cringe, Joe, but if you wake up every day, say you're a bit sad, right? And you wake up every day and you just tell yourself, another day, another dollar, just say that to yourself. It's no one else is going to know that you're saying it to yourself, right? You're going to wake up and you're going to say, another day, another dollar, I'm not dead yet. It's cringy as fuck, but it will become funny. It will be, trust me, it'll become, the 100th day that you wake up and you stretch out of bed and you go, another day, another dollar, and then it'll. We know you say it. Okay, well, I'm admitting that I say it to you guys. You don't have to, just because if you think I don't care if it's cringe. You guys care that it's cringe, but what I'm conveying is that it doesn't matter that it's cringe because no one knows that you're gonna wake up and say another day, another dollar. It's like a dad joke type shit. Alex for the 894 little boost to my TikTok account. Not saying that. Not saying that. No. Don't self promo. Please, regardless of donating, don't self-promo. It's just, it's like, okay, I'll read it. Alex Boxing 0722. Dude, yeah, bravo. Bravo. If you do it again, you're permabanned. Self-promoing is against my chat rules because it's cringe as fuck and then people spam self-shout-out. You're a lucky man that I gave you the little 894. Thanks for the 894, man. It's not really going to do much. Kyle for the sub-browser for the 300 bits. Love your content. You always make me laugh. Yeah, no, please don't self-promo. That's cringe as fuck. Brax for the 300 bets. Fun facts Friday. Have you ever heard of the ancient Greek hero Bophades? He was like... Bophades nuts. Bophades nuts. I'm not even going to read that. I already know. Because, see, look, here's the rest of the dono. He was a lot like Achilles. He had one weakness. Instead of his heel, it was his groin. You may have heard of Achilles' heel, but have you heard of Bophades nuts? Right there. The middle finger, man. That's right to you. That's right to you, man. Fuck you. Sky for the 300 bets. Should I name my pet mouse Bartman? Yes. Barbecue boy for the 300 bets. Okay, I already read all those. Clueless for the sub. Yeah, but just don't self promo. That's definitely a ban next time. For sure a ban next time. What? Wait. How did you dono to me? It says your account is suspended. That makes no sense. The kid that set the self promo has a deactivated account. That's just not true. There's no shot. Oh, it's two different Twitch accounts. Rate my TikTok profile. Oh, are you fucking kidding me, man? You really, chat, do I go to this kid's TikTok profile now? Let's go over. I'm gonna keep you the hard truth, man. I'm gonna give you the hard truth on what I think about your TikTok account. I don't know. I haven't seen it. Okay, it's literally a boxing account. Well, that was in the name. That was stupid of me to think that it was anything but boxing. You actually do get views. Bravo. Little shadow boxer, eh? Little shadow boxing. Shadow boxing in a boxing gym is okay. If you shadow box in a gym, you look like a weirdo. is that a dumb take? If you're standing in the mirror at a gym and you're fucking going, you actually look like, dude, like, no, that you're fine because you're at a boxing gym. But if you shadow box at like a Planet Fitness, figure it out. Shakespeare for the fringe bits. You know what's cringe as saying I am not dead, not being able to tear an apple in half? Okay, I did tear the apple in half, number one. Secondly, I learned that tearing an apple in half is not at all strength. It's literally just finding a crack point, and then it just breaks. Insane for the sub. Next video! Kid completes 100 airs in 24 hours. What happens next is shocking.
Come on, do it. Do it. Stick your foot in there. What, you scared of worms? Do it! Make my day. Come on. Come on.
I can't do
That's it. Like not that scary, though. Stick your foot covered in a sock in a bucket of worms. And like this man is literally hyping the shit out of him. This video is already weird. I do that for free. Somebody brings it. If one of my friends bought me a bucket of worms and they were like, yo, put your foot in this, I'd say, okay. Like, what are they going to do? Fucking bite you?
What, you scared of worms? Do it! Make my day. Come on. Come on.
I can't do it.
If you don't dip your foot in, you don't get the $10.
$10? Bitch, I'd do that for a dollar. I would do, dude, and I make money. Dude, I would do that shit for a dollar. I'm unfazed by that. I'll do that shit barefoot. Are you fine? It's a bucket of worms. Why does he have five of these lined up?
Sorry, Colin. It's too disgusting.
It's supposed to be disgusting. That's why it's called a dare. Useless. Go. All right. Anyone else?
Bro's just handing out $10. Bro's handing out $10 for fucking sticking your foot in a bucket of worms. But he hand out $10 for like people taking a shot of piss. That's worth $10. Well, it's not worth $10. It's worth for you to watch that for $10. It's not worth it for them.
No? Okay, what if I doubled the price? Any takers?
$20 to shove my foot in a bucket of worms. There's a lot of things I would do for $20, okay? And I'll keep that mentality. I don't care how much money I ever make on social media. I will keep the same mentality that $20 is $20, chat. That's a fact. No matter inflation, no matter how much money you ever make, $20 is $20. That's a fucking fact. It is. Okay, $20? What can that buy you? A lot. That could buy me like a McDouble. That could buy me a 10-piece meal at McDonald's. That could fill some of my gas tank. You got to compare it. That's dinner. That's a Valorant skin. That's an expensive Fortnite skin. Right there, $20. Boom. Little dare. Now you have the, what's a good Fortnite skin, chat? You stick your foot in a bucket of worms. What's a good Fortnite skin? Wukong. The skeleton one. Goku. Yeah, that's the Goku skin right there. Goofy for the sub, Zerxer for the 300 bets. What did you want to work as if social media didn't work out? I was initially in college for exercise science. I wanted to be a physical therapist. I got into a bunch of PT schools, and then I transferred to philosophy after I started social media.
For $20? Yeah, I'll do it. Nathan, my man. Huh. But you have to do all 5 buckets or you get nothing. Got it?
It's the same shit. If you stick your foot in a bucket of worms, it's the same shit after that. Okay, another bucket. Who cares?
As long as I get the cash, I'm in.
Nice. Dude, are you sure about this?
Oh yeah, my
we'll
god.
Be the kings of the arcades.
Okay, this is the most unrealistic Darman I've ever seen thus far. Not even the ones where, like, it's like babysitter gives kid cocaine. This is even more unrealistic than that. If you're a high school student with your friends and somebody offers you $20 to stick your foot in a bucket of worms, no shot one of your friends is going, let's think this out, man. Are you sure about this? They're obviously going to tell you to fucking do it.
That's a lot of quarters.
All right. Good luck, bro. You got this.
Nice kicks, man. All right.
Oh, the bare fucking toes.
Is dip his feet in. Then move on.
Yes, Papa. He actually did it.
Settle down. Don't get
There's like four worms and mulch in that bucket. That bucket is like 4 to 5 worms and mulch.
He actually did it.
It's not that gross.
Don't get too excited yet.
Dude, I would eat, when I was in high school, I would eat a worm for $10. Like, unironically. If you walked up to, like, junior year me, 2019, and you said, here's $10, Joe, and you handed me a fucking worm, I'd eat that shit. I'd eat that shit. I would, dude, $10? Bro, oh my God. That was, like, unfathomable, that amount of money. Dude, when I started TikTok and I made $5 on TikTok Live, I remember shitting myself. I remember literally going to school next day and being like, bro, I made $5 just from sitting there.
You still got 4 more left. You're the next one.
And get a parasite? I'm not going to get a parasite. Can you get a parasite from eating a worm? You can't get a parasite from eating a worm. Can you get a parasite from eating a ground worm? Ooh, you can get infected with a parasite by eating earthworms. See, I didn't know that. Wow. If they have eggs, you can they can go into your intestines and form cysts. Okay, maybe like $30. maybe like add a 20. And then I'll take the risk.
Oh, what is that?
It's just some milk, man.
All right. $15.
It's been expired for 2 weeks. Maybe 3. Who knows? You think you can handle it?
Dude, I hate how he's wearing his hat. Like, don't wear a hat.
3. Who knows?
Like, don't wear a hat at that point. That is not even... That's like resting on the back of your head.
You think you can handle it?
Oh, it's expired. Dude, you're putting your foot in it. It's expired. Oh, I thought they were all worm buckets. You're putting your foot in expired milk. Oh, no. The challenge would be way worse if you had to fucking drink it.
Oh, my God.
All right, Nate.
You have real potential here, man. I mean, you might as well stick your foot in anything at this point.
I feel bad now. So, why don't we wash off your feet with some sewage water, fresh from your local sewage drain?
That's disgusting.
Dude, if you gave me a hose, right, to wash off my feet, and you handed me $50, I'd walk in dog shit. I would walk, okay, and you're not holding me to this shit. I'm not going to get poop. This is not, no. This is, that would be TOS. We're not going to do this. I'm saying, if I were in the scenario where I was, like, on the beach and somebody was like, yeah, here's $50, step in dog shit, I would step in dog shit. Without a doubt. Also, chat, top 5 worst feelings when you realize you stepped in dog shit with sneakers on. The worst. And you have to pick it out with a stick. You have, like, the grains on your shoe. On God, bro. You step in dog shit and you're, like, standing outside with, like, a twig. And you're, like, scraping the poop out of the indents of your fucking shoe. If you've never done that, you have not lived. If you've never done that, you have not lived. Go step in dog shit with your sneakers on. And then you have to go scrape the poop. Like, and you have to follow the pattern of your shoes. And then you do a little grass wipe. And you have to repeat that shit. Because you're, like, you're not going to be home for, like, 8 hours. Oh, that's the fucking worst. That's actually the fucking worst. On second thought, I don't know if I would step, because like that, now I'm reminiscing on how bad that was. But if it's on my feet, it'd be easier to wash off. Stepping it, Chat, would you rather step in shit in your shoes or your bare feet? In shoes, I actually may rather step barefoot. Because then you could wash it off easier. Stepping in shit with your shoes is 10 times worse in terms of cleaning it up. Goofy and Zerxer for the sub. Cam for the 300 bets. Should I train my sister's guinea pig to be Amish? I don't think they're going to be able to do that. Alex for the 5. Sorry for the sub promo. Didn't know you're strict on that. You're chilling, bro. That's why I'm not going to ban you for like the first time you're doing it. But yeah. No, your account's chilling. It's pretty cool that you have a boxing account. Mr. Silence for the 300 bets. Lope for the 300 bets. I was studying in my dorm at 2 a.m. It's silent. I hear thudding and wood squeaking from the floor above. I stop studying to figure out what's going on. The sound gets faster and I hear a human noise. I instantly feel bad for their floor. Welcome to college, Lope. That's college. Cup for the sub. People do not care.
Oh!
What
Rotten
is
eggs
that?
And cheese and some mystery chunky stuff. I have no clue what it is. Too much for you?
All right, chat. How much do you eat that shit? How much for you to drink sewer water? Like one mouthful of sewer water? Like in the scenario where it's not going to have any adverse health effects, one gulp of sewer water. I don't even know how you would obtain sewer water, but one gulp of sewer water, that might be like 10 grand, bro. Just because that's like, that's actually gross. Like that's actually, you're eating shit. Like you're drinking poop. Somebody just said 2 pennies. You're disgusting. A Joe Bart foot pick and I drink the whole thing. Okay. Okay. There we are.
I've already come this far. There's no turning back now.
Oh, what is that? Oh.
That is kind of gross. Just give him water, and then he'll wipe
right,
it
Nathaniel,
off.
You got guts. So this next one is perfect for you.
Like, that's not that bad, bro. Dude, I would go... Have you ever gone offshore fishing? You'll fucking handle those and fucking... You'll literally be covered in slime, cutting them up, throwing it in the water. It's fucking chumming. That's not that gross. It would smell bad.
Oh, what is that?
What? Scared of fish guts?
Oh,
there's no way I can do this, Colin.
Come on, Nate. You got this. You can do it.
Come on, Nate.
Nate.
And the last bucket, your grandma's ashes. See, now that would be a good twist. What happens next is shocking. The last bucket is his grandma's ashes. That would be a good one, right? That would be like, oh, fuck. Does he step in his... Then he's stepping on his grandma's ashes. See, that's where you're like, is the $10, $20 worth it? But like, oh, a bucket of fish? No shit. I'm gonna fucking do that. Imagine he doesn't have the $20. What do you think? Dude, what was your plan? What was your plan? You fucking coming in here with like 5 buckets of this shit? You think you're stopping anyone in their tracks? You think a bucket of fish? No one's gonna fucking do that for $20?
Hey, man, where's the $20? Come on, I did it.
I could give you $20. That'd be easy. But what do you say we raise the stakes? I give you $100.
$100.
For 100 dares. And, I don't know.
100 dares? That is not worth 100 dares. First dare. Rob a fucking bank. What is the rule set on these fucking dares? Second dare. What would be a bad dare? I don't know. Go scream bomb in a fucking airport. You're gonna get arrested. Like that's not like 100 dares, $1 a dare. That's not worth it. How much money would you need to eat my country's national food, sheep balls? Sheep balls. I don't know about you guys. Those don't look that bad. Those don't. That looks pretty. That looks pretty good, doesn't it? That looks pretty good. And now I'm gonna say, yeah, when you bite into it, it's probably gonna look a bit different. But that looks like that looks pretty good. That looks like a little. It looks like chicken, like a little encrusted chicken. It's definitely not gonna taste like that. See here. What about this? Like this looks like Chick-fil-A. This is testicles. That looks good. I would try that for free, especially with a little lemon on it. A little nibble of the sheep balls. I might try that out. 100 dares for $100 though, not worth. Mr. Silence for the 500 bits. Hey Joe, me and my boyfriend have been going through a lot right now due to some of my problems. You've been helping with me a lot, or you've been helping me a lot lately. Keep up the good work. Dash Angie. Thank you. For the 500 bits. And I'm glad I could help. And I'm sorry that you're going through shit right now.
24 hours? Starting now.
No. No way, man. That's so many dares. Don't do it, Nate.
Okay. Man, I hear you. So how about each bucket he's already done counts for one dare each? I mean,
that's still 95 fucking dares. For $100? Dude, work at Walmart for 8 hours. Work at Walmart for 8 hours. Instead of risking whatever the fuck this kid's gonna come up with you to fucking do.
It's only 95 dares.
What are you doing, man? Just get the
and 95
bucks,
dares is gonna take more than 8 hours.
Do you know what's better than arcades? Go-karts? Laser tags? Batting cages?
Are you talking about Fun World?
Come on.
Dude, we have...
Talking about Fun World? Bro, $100 at like an arcade? Chat, how long is that? Be real. I love Dave and Buster's. You throw $100 down at Dave and Buster's, that's about 3 hours. You got about 3 hours of fucking gaming. Right? You got about 3 hours. If you're playing the high expensive games, you're playing that basketball shit, you got about 3 hours. Maybe two. Yeah, chat's actually saying two. Maybe two. That's not worth it. 100 dares for 2 hours at fucking Dave and Buster's? No.
I've been there forever.
And I fucking love Dave and Buster's. And this 100 dare shit not worth. Really? Yes. I mean, if you're spending the points like very like cautiously, you could probably spend like 6 hours there. But if you're going in to Dave and Buster's with $100 worth of tickets on like a regular day, not a half priced. Wait, is it half price Wednesday or half price Tuesday? See, I know my Dave and Buster's shit. What day is Dave and Buster's half off? Wednesdays. If you're going to Dave and Buster's on a Wednesday with $100 in tickets, you could probably be there for like 4 hours max. Zerkster for the 300 bets. If you're gaming nonstop, Gordon Ramsay tried sheep balls and spat them out because they're so disgusting. Oh really? Yeah, but like encrusted like that with a lemon, they look pretty good. Nitron for the 300 bets. You either die a hero or live long enough to see yourself become a villain. Day 4 out of 100. A little fucking movie quote there, eh?
You really think you can do it?
Nitron Day 4, thank you for the 3 times. Hello, what's up?
See you in class.
What are the dares gonna be?
Hey, dude, how are you gonna come up with 95 more dares?
Oh, don't worry about it, man. I already got the next one. Check this out.
A whoopee cushion. That is so lame, bro. Chat, when was the last time y'all used a whoopee cushion? I was like 8. Like 8 years old. You don't use a whoopee cushion unless you're fucking like 5 years old, right? That's like dad humor and like elementary school, bro. Dare to shoot up a school? Bro, come on. First dare of the 95 remaining dares. He hands him a fucking pistol. Jesus Christ. I mean, yeah, that would be a way to win. I dare you to get up and hit a devious gritty. I'm not hitting the gritty, Shakespeare. Thank you for the 300 bets. Cereal for the sub. Goldie for the 300 bets. 100 dares in 24 hours is like 1 per 15 minutes. Yeah, that sucks. Sit on this. Dare number nine. Dare number six. Sit on this.
Now? Yeah, man. Clock's ticking.
No way, man. It's disgusting. Plus, everyone's gonna think I got gas for real.
Alright, man. I thought you were...
Bro, are you fucking kidding me? You're gonna do 95 dares and you're hesitant about sitting on a fucking whoopee cushion?
Anything, but...
Fine, just give it to me.
Bro, you know... Okay, here's a good dare. To make this kid fucking lose, here's a good dare. Eat 5 laxatives and don't go to the bathroom. He'll shit himself. You will shit your pants. That is humiliating. You're gonna be done. The challenge is over. Boom, there. Okay, you gotta keep your $100.
All right, can someone tell me how to...
What is this class of, 5 people? Oh, not the quadratic equation.
Now, class, that's nothing to laugh at. We can move past it. It's perfectly natural. There's no need to keep laughing.
Dude, it's, actually not funny, though. I actually wouldn't laugh.
Okay, can we continue our class now? Thank you.
Haha, funny farts. Wait, there's one video I gotta show y'all. It's the funniest video I've ever seen. Genuinely the funniest video I've ever seen. It's a TikTok video. I gotta pull it up. Hold up. It was so long ago, though. I gotta find the video. Dude, it was the funniest shit ever. I'm telling you, you're gonna die laughing. It's the only fart video that I actually deem as funny.
Oh my god.
Alright, I gotta keep scrolling. Dude, they post so much. It's on Barstool Sports. Where is it? Here. It's even farther down. Holy fucking shit. Dude, this shit was posted so long ago. I'm gonna be scrolling forever. Devoted for the sub, Hedron for the 300 bits. Would you ever be in a Darman video? Chat, if Darman ever reached out for me to be in a video, would you guys want me to be in it? TTV for the sub. I think that would be fucking hilarious. If I was ever in a Darman video, what would I even be in? I would be in the 100 dares one. I wouldn't be able to take it seriously though. I would just get mad. I'd be like, this is a terrible idea, Darman. Let's fucking think of something else here, man. Wait, I think I found it. Did I find it? I found it. It's not, what is this? This is not the video. Here it is. All right, hold up.
What the fuck, dude? You're gonna act like that was a cop?
Sorry.
No, seriously, get out of here. What the fuck, dude? You're gonna act like that was a cop?
Sorry.
Bro coughs and then farts 5 seconds later.
What the fuck, dude?
Oh, that's the funniest video I've ever seen. Actually the funniest video I've ever seen. Bro, that is so fucking funny. Oh my god. Oh my god. You get in an elevator, and then you fucking fart. Dude, I might do that. Should I fucking do that one day? I might go in public and do that shit. I'm just in a... If I had a rip ass, I just want to see... It would be like a public reaction. I would want to see what people would do. Do you think they would actually say anything if I fucking walk into an elevator, I cough, and then I just brutally rip ass? Zerk, sir, for the 300 bits. Screaming guy screams at mother and her infant, instantly regrets it. Yeah, that probably would be a me Darman video.
I just think I have some gas.
Dude, that's not even how a whoopee cushion works. You have to, reinflate it.
Mr. Fuller, that's a whoopee cushion. Now, cut it out. I'm serious.
Bro, take the whoopee cushion from him.
Now, as I was saying...
Bro, he's gonna do it again?
All right, that's it. You're getting detention.
F. Bro did that. Bro got detention for $1. Bro got detention for 100 pennies. Wow.
There goes Bruno.
Still has 94 left.
I don't know what he's doing here.
Dude, he legitimately scares me. Rumor has it he failed 8th grade 4 times.
What?
Anyway, I still can't believe you farted 10 times.
Yep, 85 more dares to go. As long as it's not snakes or anything.
Oh, so they're just gonna cut out 90% of the dares?
That, like spiders, I'll be okay. Hey, Nate. What's good? Ready for your next year?
Can I finish my lunch first?
Don't worry about your lunch. You're gonna finish lunch, just not yours. See Bruno over there? See? I want you to take a bite of his sandwich.
No way, man. I'm not trying to die. Just give me something else to do.
Sorry, man. That's the dare. But each bite counts.
You couldn't get, like, a scarier person? That guy is of, like, average build. Take a bite of his sandwich. He looks like a regular guy. You couldn't get like a bodybuilder or some scary motherfucker.
Yeah.
Sorry, man, that's the dare. But each bite can count as one dare.
The more bites I take, the less chance I have of surviving. No way.
Eat the whole sandwich, it'll be worth 20 dares. See, even he agrees.
Oh, snap. Man,
gonna do it.
Got this.
This isn't that scary. That's why they need me. I would be the guy they bite the sandwich out of. Doubt it.
What do you want, Fuller?
Please forgive me for this.
Hey, what do you think you're...
That is a nasty-ass sandwich, too. And how are they measuring the... Oh, he has to just eat the whole sandwich for 20 dares. Dude, that's like a turkey and lettuce. That's fucking gross.
Please forgive me for this.
I would be more upset that I had to eat a turkey and lettuce than I was stealing somebody's sandwich. That's a bad sandwich.
Hey, what do you think you... Did you just... Stop that.
Hurry up, Nate. Get out of there.
Stop eating my sandwich.
Sorry.
Get that back.
I'm sorry.
Hey, what are you doing? I can take my...
Damn.
I'll give you another sandwich. Just don't kill me.
You're dead meat, Fuller.
You're dead meat, Fuller. Meanwhile,
hey, what are you doing?
Like this.
Let me take my...
Please, I promise I'll give you another sandwich.
Like, that is not scary in a fight. I'm not even trying to be mean. I'm just saying, they could have gotten, like, a more intimidating bully. Like, they could have. He's not scary. Like, they were portraying that he's, like, held back for 4 years and he's much older than them. He looks almost the same age as them, and he's just tall. He's tall. That's it.
Just don't kill me!
You're dead meat, Fuller.
Dude, he ate the whole thing. He's up to 35 now.
I can count, Lee. Let's go see if he's still alive.
Dude, his hat needs to go. This kid's whole personality is the fucking hat. He just keeps futzing with it. It's sitting up there. He has it forward. He has it back. He has it side. Just fucking pick a place for the hat to sit.
Guys, over here in the trash.
Don't tell me you got stuffed in the trash.
Yo,
how the fuck did you get in there? How the fuck did you get in there while you were being chased?
Over here in the trash. What are you doing in there?
Hiding from Bruno. Was he gone?
Yeah, he just left.
I can't believe you did that.
Oh, wait.
How did you get in there? You wouldn't fit.
Stay in there. For your next dare, I want you to let people throw garbage on you.
Come on, man. On chilly day?
Dude.
Oh. See, that's a rough dare. On fucking chilly day? Chilly day, nobody eats that shit. You just fucking toss that bitch at him?
He doesn't have much time left.
Why didn't you say you were going to be live early? Because I didn't know I was going to be live early till today. Because I'm going to a haunted house later. Taco for the 300 bits. Look up a TikTok snake farting? No. Hi for the sub. Shakespeare for the 300 bits. I went to a new... What is a TikTok snake farting? I went to a new block at school... a new block at college, and this old teacher said to me... Sorry, you aren't allowed to gritty in the halls. It's against the school code of conduct. Also, the guy in the cap looks like you. He does not look like me. Okay, that was upsetting that you just fucking said that. He does not look like me. Joe for the sub to Baba for the sub. Does this guy look like me, chat?
Waste any.
It's fine. All right, I'll do the dare. But each person counts as one.
Fine by me.
Dude, this guy looks nothing like me. Like, actually nothing like me. That guy looks more like me. What is that face he just made? Hedron for the sub. Bro, what is this kid? Is he trying to be like a fucking model? I'm just fucking walking around holding a book, flexing his jaw, sucking the cheeks in. Hedron for the 5 gifteds. Thank you for the 5 gifteds, bro. Is that Hedron? How do you say that? Hedron? 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 Hedron 1? Thank you for the fucking 5 gifted subs. Big dubs. Oh no. Not on chilly day.
It's one.
Okay, they're just throwing out like paper. We need to see a full chilly day.
Yeah, I can do a couple more.
How did they not see him? I would see someone in the fucking trash can.
It's a shame this soup is so spicy. I could barely eat it.
Yeah, I'll talk to the chef. If it's too hot to eat, just throw it away.
Stop!
Nathan? Is that you?
Who the fuck? Where did he get bologna on his head?
I'm looking for my retainers. I think I dropped it in here.
Did you really have to climb all the way in? That's disgusting. You're lucky this hot soup isn't all on you.
Just set it here for now. Nathan, get out of there, please.
And they leave him? The teachers just say, yeah, get out of the trash can and walk away? They don't fucking help him? They're just yeah, get out of the trash can, man.
You alright, man?
That was a close one, but once I get the $100, it'll all be worth it.
Dude, teachers would be pissed. For no fucking reason, too. If the kid wants to hide in the trash can, he can hide in the trash can. In my opinion. If I'm a teacher and some kid's in the trash can, I'm gonna say, you're a fucking idiot. And I'm just gonna walk away. Right? But other teachers, realistically, a teacher would get hard-pressed. Realistically, a teacher's gonna be like, are you fucking kidding me? You're in the trash can. How childish of you.
I lost and found and find some extra clothes.
So I'm gonna take this to the next level.
This is stealing! Now you're actually committing crimes. For your last dare, he pulls out a heroin needle. You're gonna try heroin. If he can do any dare, there's no guidelines, bro. Give him crack. Like he's not gonna fucking do it. For $100, you're gonna do crack for $1. Like that's not worth it. So smooth, Kevin on a roll. Now you see a stars like Vinny Van Gogh. Ain't nothing gonna hold you back when you got it like that. When you got it like that. Ain't nothing gonna What are we in High School fucking Musical, dude? Fucking Tough Guy Shiver Me Timbers, bro. Fucking. When you got it like that. What happens is shocking. He ends up getting shanked. Like he. Dude, I'm making fun of this guy. Dude, this guy at the end of the video just literally fucking stabs him. Is he pissing himself? When you got it like that. When you got it like that. Did he piss himself? Somebody redeemed heads at that? Dude, my hair just looks fucking awful all the time now. Livings for the sub, David for the sub, Nitron for the 300 bits. Hack into a military base mainframe and launch missiles at Bruno. Will you be doing a costume stream for Halloween? If so, I vote for maid or emo guy. I'll choose the costume myself. I'm gonna do a Halloween-based stream where I rate my viewers' Halloween costumes. From like previous years and this year. I don't know when I'm gonna open the Discord channel for people to submit their costumes, but I will be rating costumes.
Alright, y'all chill here. Go and get your next dare ready. I don't know how long I could keep this up. I'm exhausted.
Dude, you're at 91. Just a few more to go.
Dude, he's breezing through these dares. You may have to fork over the 100 bucks.
Yo, this, like, low-key is the best friend to have, though. If you have a friend that's worth to... not the best friend because it makes you a bad friend, but it's the most entertaining friend. If you have a friend that's worth... that is willing to do anything for $100, that's, like, insane. Like, that's actually, like... like, you and your friend group fork over $10 and your friend literally just fucking walks into a bank and, like, steals shit. That would be absurd. Like, your friend's getting arrested, but they're willing to do that for $100. Like, he literally stole gold wedding rings and shit from a woman for a dollar. For a dollar.
Soon. That's not gonna happen.
What? Why not?
I don't have the money. Didn't have the tool.
Go steal the bathroom urinal.
Getting with.
Then why'd you make the deal?
I didn't think he'd make it this far.
You should never make an agreement you can't keep. It'll come
up. The foreshadowing, chat. I guarantee you they repeat that.
Back to hurt you.
Dude, don't worry about it. It'll be fine. Especially...
never make an agreement you can't keep.
This next one's simple. You do what I tell you, when I tell you. No questions asked.
What's your game?
Hey, don't worry about it, okay? We'll see.
No, why I'm just like, if I was this kid and I did 100 dares and this kid didn't give me the money, I'd actually beat the shit out of him. Like, I'd actually lose my mind. I would be like, bro, I just spent all fucking day doing 100 dares. He's gonna get his ass kicked. There's no doubt that this guy, I'm calling it right now. Who's that big guy? Who's the one that's supposed to be the scary guy? What was his name? Whatever that big guy's name is going to beat this kid up. He's not going to beat him up. He's going to beat this kid up. Bruno. Bruno's going to beat the shit out of this kid by the end of the fucking day.
Come with me. God, this...
scream, I have fun in class for the final dare. That's not even a scary dare. I have fun in class. What?
All right.
Oh, scream, I have a gun in class. Okay, see, now that's a dare. Now that's a dare. You said scream, I have fun in class. You meant scream, I have a gun. Okay, that's different.
Hot shot. Ready for your first one?
I was about to say, that shit is cringe as fuck.
Why don't you stand up, tell everyone... wearing a diaper?
If you have an accident, it'll be fine.
Bro, you're doing that for $1. You're gonna walk, you're gonna fucking proclaim to the public that you're, if you shit yourself, it's fine because you have a diaper on. I want the kid to do it so the kid that is not gonna pay him ends up getting fucking like...
just in case anyone was wondering, I'm wearing a diaper, so if I have an accident, I'll be okay.
Easy enough. Now, I want you to go up to the counter and order the following.
Toilet water with a side of whipped cream and a pinch of armpit hair on top.
Dude, this is like actually cringy ass like elementary school shit. This is unfunny as fuck. Like, that's not even a funny dare. That's just annoying. Like, if I like, the workers are just gonna be annoyed. That's so annoying.
Come on, you got it.
Joe, people do this stuff for free. Jadeon walked around saying he's looking for his hairline. I'm going to let you in. I love Jadeon, okay? I'm going to let you in on a little secret, man. Jadeon is making money off of the videos, right? So, like, Jadeon's not walking. While Jadeon may be okay with doing it for free, he's making thousands of dollars off of the video if it's monetized, right? Like, say a YouTube video is monetized and it gets 2 million views. That's, like, $8,000, right? That's, like... That's not for free. I mean, I don't know if his videos are getting monetized, but I love Jadeon, right? And he might do it for free. Knowing Jadeon, he might walk around in public and do that shit for free. However, this is his job, right? It's social media is the job, right? Like, you could say, I'm doing this, but I'm still getting paid. Regardless of me wanting to stream, you're still getting paid. Regardless of Jadeon wanting to do it for free or something, he's still getting paid. That's just how it is.
Oh, hi. How can I help
you? Why are you saying it like that? Why am I saying what like that?
Please forgive me for this.
Mr. Silence for the 300 bits, you should visit Aruba sometime. That would be good. That would be fucking fun. I don't even know when I would do that, though. ZZ for the 300 bits and Hedron for the 1,000 bits. Last air for $100, blow up one of the teachers with this RPG. Where the fuck would he get an RPG? X4 for the sub, X-Just for the sub. Taco Bell for the 300 bits. There's literally probably going to be pull the fire alarm. If the last one is pull the fire alarm, that's actually so annoying. That's going to be like the fucking worst air ever. Pull the fire alarm.
Hi, can I please have a milkshake with toilet water and a little bit of whipped cream and a pinch of your armpit hair?
Cringe.
Do you guys not have that here? I'm sorry.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Like, I would not want to be this kid's friend. If you thought that was funny, that is, like, actually so annoying.
All right. You've done well. Now, I want you...
Yeah, you see that nice happy couple back there?
Ah, that's right. I want you to go sit on that dude's lap and call him dad.
That's a good dare. Doesn't that count as like sexual harassment? Like you're literally sitting on someone and calling them dad. Bro, no shot.
Please forgive me for this.
What are you doing?
Dad!
I found
you! What? It's been so long since I've seen you. Dad, you're finally home!
Is there something you're forgetting to tell me?
No, honey, you must be confused. Look, I'm not your dad, kid.
When are you coming home, Papa? We've been missing him. Oh, Papa! Papa! I love you! Papa! Dad!
Richard, do you have a secret family you never told me about?
No, I swear!
Papa, oh my god, like any woman would fucking believe this kid. Oh, Jesus Christ. You're fucking kidding me.
Mama have been waiting for him at home. Papa! I found you, Papa. Papa! Oh, Papa! So happy, Papa! I found you, Papa!
Honey,
Papa.
Come back, please. I don't know this kid. What's wrong with you?
Ruined a relationship for a dollar. Oh, yeah, also, wasn't that not a part of the dare? Didn't all he had to do was sit on... All he had to do was sit on his lap and call him dad. He, like, went in on that shit. He, like, kept going.
Oh, that wasn't funny. That was hilarious. One last lap before the grand finale.
You only got a few minutes left. You refuse any of these dares, you're done. You got that? I introduce you to my brother's pets. Lizzie the Lizard. I dare you to pet her.
That doesn't seem too bad.
That's not bad at all.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Woo! Ah, that wasn't bad. Woo, let's go, see. Let's go.
Let's see how you do with the next one.
No way. No way, man. I can't do that.
You somehow have the cape. Oh my God, look at my hair. You somehow have the capability of going and getting cages of tarantulas, all this other shit. You're transporting it. You're buying curtains. You're doing all that. Like, okay, you're telling me you haven't spent any money on this and you can do all of this, but you don't have $100 to your fucking name. You don't have $100 you can give this kid for the dares, but you're willing to spend all day trying to get this kid to fucking lose and bringing all this shit from home. How are you affording this?
So you back out. Is this the end? Hey, look.
I understand he's saying it's his brother's shit, but like he's getting all these curtains and tables and all this other stuff.
I want to do it. Don't. But this is the 99th dare. You're so close. Come on.
Dude, it's for $100. It's his brother's pets. Dude, that doesn't matter. He's getting all that. Dude, it's like he has all this revealed shit. He had to fucking go home and get his brother's pets. Dude, it's easier to just give a kid $100 than go through with this. Because they're not at his house. He went back to the school. You just ask your mom for fucking money. Because your mom's going to be pissed at you. But if you made a fucking agreement, they're going to pay the kid. Or just, yeah, literally just work. Dude, initially, don't double down for the 100 dares. Just go home, get $20, and give it to the kid. Like, even if you don't have $20, you can get $20 in a day if you were required to. You could somehow obtain $20 by, like, mowing a lawn. Like, you could.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, ah! 6, ah!
Ooh! I'd rather eat 100 Bruno sandwiches than do that again. Okay, what's that?
You ready for the last one?
He pulls out a dime bag of meth. You're gonna be snorting crystal.
Here we go.
No way. No way. No! Oh, what is that?
It's a snake. It'd be a snake. That'd be a snake. That's what that is.
You give up?
Dude, I can barely...
Hey, Nathan. Look at me. Think about everything you've been through, okay? Okay? You're gonna throw it all away if you give up now. He can. He's a quitter. And he's only got 30 seconds left.
Deep breath.
Oh my God, just touch it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ah! Oh, my God, pay up! Yeah. Pay up!
Well, like, why is this kid so confident? That's your last dare, pet a snake? Brother's 99 dares in, you don't think he's gonna fucking do it?
Pay up! Woo! About that.
I don't have the money, immediately grabbing him by the ankles, fucking Hulk throwing him into the wall. You fucking made an agreement for $100. He spent 24 hours doing a dare and you don't have $100. Give me your hat. Give me your hat. Give me your fucking jacket. Give me everything in your pockets, bro. I'm fucking robbing this motherfucker at that point. Yeah, get the fuck out of here.
I don't have the 100.
What? Are you kidding me?
No, I didn't think you're actually gonna do it. I mean,
if you make an agreement like that, you stick to it.
Wow, you're a cheat, a dirty cheat.
So everything I did was for no reason. I got chili dumped on me. I stepped on fish feces. I almost got beat up by Bruno.
You're gonna pay for what you did.
I'm sorry about the sandwich and the spitballs.
Not only that, but my parents came home fighting last night. She thinks my dad has a secret kid. And when I asked her what happened...
Oh my God! Yo, dude, I'm telling you, did I call it, chat? Did I call it, though, that Bruno beats the fuck out of this kid? Did I call it, though? There's a chance here. There's a chance here.
She showed me a picture she took, and it was of you!
I'm sorry, please, please, please don't hurt me, please!
Give me
please,
one good reason why I shouldn't.
It wasn't his fault. Yeah. Those were all dares. Yeah. Dares that Colin made him do.
That's right.
What? You put him up to this?
No,
I fucking called it! Dude, I am literally a Darman wizard. I am a Darman wizard. I can fucking... Dude, get me the fuck out of here, bro. Like, I literally said that shit. Bruno's gonna beat the fuck out of this kid because he didn't pay him the money.
Perfectly reasonable explanation. Hey, Nathan. for your last dare, to help Eli enough.
No! I'm done! I'm done listening to him. It's true. He put me
Wait, for your last dare. I thought he was done the last dare. Hey, Nathan, for your last dare. For your last dare, he was done the dares. I'd punch him square in the nose.
No, I'm done. I'm done listening to him. It's true. He put me up to all the dares. It was Colin's idea. Please let me go.
Big mistake, Colin.
I try to warn him. If you make a deal you can't keep, it'll come back to hurt you.
Looks like it's hurting him pretty bad.
I just really wanted to go to fun around at least.
Oh. Hey, I never gave these back.
Oh, he gets to keep the AirPods. Oh, that's a dub. Oh, that's a dub. He gets to keep the AirPods. Oh, yeah, that's worth. That's worth. That's worth. Keeps the AirPods. Gets getting his ass kicked by Bruno.
It's payback, huh?
Actually, I've been meaning to get some.
Can I buy them off of you for $100?
Wait, really?
Yeah.
Heck yeah! Oh, we got a fine line! Let's go! Woo!
Woo! This kid hasn't said one word. I can't get over it. Dude, who the fuck are these two? What does that say? Don't burst my bubble, double bubble. Oh, God. This kid hasn't talked, though.
Wait, really?
Look, look at the silent
Heck
reactions
yeah.
from the two, the two back characters.
Let's go!
Look, he thinks he's a big shot.
My God. It's me for the sub. He's at for the 3 bits. How's your day? How was your day so far? I hope it was well. It was chilling. Had to go to the DMV. Another rip. Little F in the chat that I had to go to the DMV. I have to go back again. DMV is hell. I will stick by that statement. Barna for the sub. Rig for the sub. Hero for the sub. ZZ for the 300 bits. I think I'm caught up on the donos. Let's get into the next one. Chat, what are the odds this is TOS? Okay. Number one, he may or may not. I don't know what. Chat, just look at the scan, right? Okay, look at the scan. Look at the scan. Look at the scan while I'm scanning it. Okay, there's nudity, but it's blurred. I feel like I just skip past the nudity, and it should be fine. Because the nudity kind of ends after, like, the first... Okay, no, he's butt-ass naked there. The nudity ends, like, a minute in, I thought. See, I don't know. I gotta do a poll. Joe, that was not blurred. Yes, it was. I literally pre-scanned the video for, like, 5 minutes before a stream. Don't try and fucking tell me that it wasn't blurred, you dumbass. Do we watch this? I don't know if we watch this. Because I don't know if this is TOS. Can my mods give me their opinion on whether or not this is TOS? Because it's an age-restricted YouTube video as well. So all of that accumulated kind of makes me think that, yeah, I don't think we risk this. If I was just posting a YouTube video of this, I wouldn't be worried. But I don't know if we risk watching that. Most people are saying no to watching it. Because I don't want to take the chance. Especially because he does drink his own piss in this video. And he straight up moons the camera, but it's blurred. Yeah, I'm not. No, we're not going to watch that. All right. Fuck. Okay. Yeah, I just did it. I want to watch it. But I know the odds of that being TOS out of every video I've seen thus far on stream is pretty fucking high. Do we watch a different Channel 5 video then? I wouldn't risk it even if it's on YouTube. Twitch's TOS is different. Yeah, they're more strict. Channel 5, Andrew. We'll watch a different Channel 5 video. Do you guys want to watch a different one? Because they have other ones that are fucking good as shit. Maddie for the sub. Let's go to most popular. Daytona Bike Week, Q Conference, Daytona Bike Week. Do we watch that one?
Lundberg.
Somebody said More Darman. I don't know about More Darman. What are the odds this is TOS?
Better than Daytona Bike Week at the Cackleberry Campground.
Okay. What about this?
Nothing better than Daytona Bike Week at the Cackleberry Campground.
Do you have any special talents?
Hey, rubbing her, making her feel...
Oh, God damn it. Dude, everything's blurred out. Fuck! Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Okay, wait. I think that was literally the only thing that would be blurred. Because I literally scanned the video while I was talking. I think everything else should be fine. I think it should be fine.
Feel good.
How does it make you feel?
Having fun. Oh, life is great. Life is great.
How's it going?
What you doing?
Just doing it. Got to get that whipped cream on there.
All right, baby. Here in Daytona Beach, Florida at the Cabbage Patch Campground. It's Daytona Bike Week. What's the craziest thing you've seen so far in this amazing week?
Yeah, I would say the coleslaw wrestling. Wrestling in shredded lettuce, cabbage, and oil. How does the coleslaw feel?
Who the fuck comes up with that? Fucking coleslaw wrestling? Turn it off? Nah, this is a good video.
Fucking wet and cold?
This is a good video, though. This is a good video, though, chat. Come on.
I bartend and I work for the DOD, Department of Defense. Yeah, I do criminal investigations.
You do criminal investigations and you're out here at fucking Daytona, Florida doing coleslaw wrestling? Wow.
She's in good hands.
Have you got to ride a bike yet?
Yeah, I got to ride a bike. They told me I was the fattest dude he ever had on his bike.
I was just told that your name here isn't Saddam. You got a name change?
Yeah, they call me Brandon.
Yeah! Fuck Joe Biden!
Oh, this is Daytona. This is Daytona.
Fucking love it.
I fucking love it.
Really?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Hell yeah. Let's go, Daytona. Let's go, Bike Week.
Oh, do we watch this whole video, though, chat? Do we watch this? This is a 30-minute video. Most people are saying no. I'm gonna say we skip that 30-minute. It would be good for like a late night. It'd be good for like a late night Chicago Rap Festival, dude. Hollywood anti-vax Chet Hanks interview. Okay, what other video do we watch? We'll watch some llama arts. Yeah, get the fuck out of here. Llama arts. All right, we'll watch this. What about this? Who will find the real drug dealer? We'll watch a Jubilee video. This is one of you sent this shit. Who will find the real drug dealer? We'll watch this. Buttercup for the 1,000 bits. I skipped school today because somebody wrote on the floor they were going to shoot up my school today. Well, I mean, good shit that you skipped. Holy fuck. Thank you for the 1,000 bits. I'm sorry that somebody wrote that on the fucking floor. Holy shit. Sharer for the sub and Panda for the sub. We're not watching scary videos right now. We end off with scary videos. We'll watch who will find the real drug dealer. I'm sorry. This is why I don't let you guys choose the video because everybody's always so skewed. Darman, scary videos, Channel 5, this. So I let you guys recommend me videos. I choose what we watch. Yeah, another kid just said llama arts. Get the fuck out of here. Llama arts horror. I'm timing you out for saying llama arts, buddy. I'm not watching llama arts right now. We'll start out with this. Who will find the real drug dealer? Cops versus stoners.
Five are posers. One is the real deal. Our teams.
Damn.
I am Lay.
I'm Ronnie. And we're stoners.
Yo, what's up? I'm Danny.
Hey, I'm Dorian.
And we're law enforcement.
Danny and Dorian. Liars,
can these teams find the real deal? Each team has 15 minutes to find the real deal. Anytime within those 15 minutes, a team can lock in their answer.
All right, first of all...
Who looks like a drug dealer off-rip? Guy in the tats, I feel like they want to make you think that he is. I'm saying four. I'm saying number four. I'm saying far left. That looks like a drug dealer. He looks like a drug dealer. Like, dude, far left, man bun, chill kind of guy, it's him. He sells pot, and he sells pills on the side, no doubt. Do they arrest them after this? I doubt it.
Everybody with pants, I'm going to I need to see how high your socks are. Because they say the higher the socks, the downer the person is. So. All right, we got the ankles on deck. Now, these are pretty high. I got a question for number 3. How many grams in an ounce?
28.
Ooh.
But yeah, you could know that and not be a drug dealer. You could know that and just be somebody like the stoners would know that, and they don't sell drugs.
That quick? How many grams in a pound?
How many grams in a pound? Mm-hmm. Well, ain't that good?
Who's been arrested?
How many ounces are in a pound? Fuck. See, I don't know measurements. I know 28 grams in an ounce. How many ounces in a pound? Is it 12? Is it 12 ounces in a pound? How many ounces in a pound? I think it might be 12. It's 16. Okay, I was wrong.
What have you all been arrested for?
Smuggling narcotics through an airplane.
Okay. What?
Standing on the corner, slanging that thing.
Misdemeanor drug possession.
Oh, they've all been arrested. Oh.
Smuggling narcotics through an airplane.
Okay. Standing on the corner, slanging that thing.
Misdemeanor drug possession.
So he got arrested for... Oh, wait, no, they're lying. Wait, are they lying? Because that guy just said he got arrested for selling drugs.
Personal possession, selling.
I got arrested for smuggling weed into Mexico.
Okay. All right, group.
Smuggling weed into Mexico.
I got arrested for smuggling weed into Mexico.
That's a thing?
All right, group. Green, black, or white?
Green.
Black.
Let's talk about the colors.
We knew there was going to be someone who didn't know what that meant.
If you were about that life, you knew what it meant, so.
Right away.
What's green?
Flag of Mexico.
Hmm?
The flag of Mexico.
What's black?
Power.
What's white?
What's white? That's a neutral color right there.
What's black?
Tar heroin.
What's green?
Weed.
What's white?
Coke.
The man?
Huh?
The man?
Okay.
All right, we're making an elimination at this time.
Each team will try to find the real deal by eliminating the imposters.
Redo the predictions and just do 1, 2, 3, 4. End that prediction. End prediction. / prediction. Refund that. I'll leave it here. Delete. Delete that. Delete that shit. Redo it here and you guys can vote 1, 2, 3, or 4. I genuinely believe 4. I think 4. For sure. 2 definitely doesn't sell drugs. No. 1, 5, 6. 6, no shot. 6, no shot. That's an immediate elimination. No shot, 6. I think 4. 4 looks like he sells pot. And I don't think they're going to bring a drug dealer that's selling, like, meth. And so I feel like the easiest person to just look is like, who looks like they sell weed? 4. All right, now do the predictions.
Both teams eliminate this.
What are most people putting? Most people are putting 3 and 4. This guy did literally say he got arrested for drug dealing. So if he is the drug dealer, that wouldn't be shocking. Most people are putting 3, 4, and 6. Why are people, so many people putting 6? Maybe because they want you to think that it's not 6. Why the fuck is he looking at the camera like this?
Same person.
Nap for the sub, asleep for the sub.
The game.
Who do you want to go with? I say. Well, we eliminated number 5.
Because he was a model.
I've never really seen a pretty drug dealer before, so.
He had that.
They eliminated him because he was attractive. That was the cop's fucking gut opinion.
Because he was a model.
I've never really seen a pretty drug dealer before, so.
He had that. Look.
I mean, he is an attractive man. Admittedly, this man is attractive. He also has a heart near his eyes.
For the whole group, I want to go.
You can't say Ayo. I don't give a shit if you say Ayo. That man's attractive. He is an attractive man. That's a fact. That guy is attractive. He has perfect facial features. He has a nice hair. He has a nice haircut, tats, nice beard. Bro, come on. Bro, come on. Come on, man. Come on. We gotta admit things here. He's attractive.
Look.
For for the whole group.
Oh shit, I forgot the stoners could guess too.
Round in order and see how much money has everybody made last year.
I made $350,000.
Is this documented or undocumented money? Say that on camera.
It could be undocumented.
Yeah, it could be both.
Probably like $250K.
Between $150,000
and $200,000. I'm a
defendant. Okay, they ain't dealing weed then. They're not dealing weed. You're not making $300K a year selling weed on the fucking corner unless you're selling by the pound or some shit. They gotta be selling some other shit. What the fuck are they selling?
Didn't smell time, $3,500.
See, nah! No, it has to be him, bro. I'm dead ass thinking it, dude. Because he was just dead honest about that. Yeah, like $4,000.
Between $150,000 and $200,000.
I'm a dependent, small time, $3,500.
Yeah, he's just selling to his friends. He's selling weed to his friends. See, does that count as a drug dealer, though? I don't know.
I made about $150K the last time. But
nah, yeah, this guy's lying. He ain't the fucking drug dealer.
You guys with me?
Between $80 and $150 back in the day.
Okay. What are you guys having?
Okay, so they might not have to be a drug dealer now. It's if they were ever a drug dealer.
Whole group
going out to brunch, just hanging out, watching reruns of SpongeBob. You know, yeah. I mean, I'm practically retired. Yeah.
I like the bus down.
Bus down.
I like the bus down. Every day of the week, buddy.
I want to know. They should ask them how they get to keep the money, right? Because if you're making $300,000 undocumented, you're gonna have to somehow launder that money. To be able to keep it. Because if you just have 300, if somebody gives you $300K in cash undocumented, you're not going to be able to spend a lot of that without eventually the government being sus. If you're spending $300K a year undocumented every year, you're going to have to launder that money. And if they don't know how they can explain that, then it's not them.
Trying to get paid. There you go.
I hike a lot. I play guitar. I smoke.
I really just be smoking, hitting the gym. I don't get out the house much. I'm not really a social person.
Okay. I don't do shit anymore.
Do you have 31 work, for the summer?
I see my kid.
We would like to make an elimination.
As a reminder, if both teams eliminate the same person, that person will be removed from the game.
Now I'm fucking questioning myself, bro. Nah, now I'm questioning myself. Because he looks like, dude, he deadass, like, I know people that look like him that sell drugs. Like, I literally, and hey, the fuck? I goddamn can't move my goddamn chair. Okay. I know people that look like him that sell drugs. Like, 10 people that look like him that sell drugs. Like, no, like, there's no doubt, bro. Come on.
He sounded too happy-go-lucky for me. And it was like, dude, you're hiking? Like, I was like, oh yeah, this dude, he's gone.
What made you stop dealing drugs?
Well, I can't. I got tired of going to jail, bro.
I decided to stop just because I saw how it was affecting people around me.
Okay. Nah, it's not him. It's not him. I saw how it was affecting those around me. Bro. You're selling drugs, okay?
Friends get locked up.
I thought he was gonna say I felt bad for the people I was selling to. I was gonna say, bro, come on. No, there's no shot.
Happening. I wanted better for myself.
My nephew was knifed. Didn't make it.
Wow.
What does it mean to be on deck?
Dude, maybe it's him in the back. Cause he's just like stone cold about it. Maybe he didn't answer that one question right because he hasn't been selling drugs in forever.
To be ready to rock and roll?
Ready to go, ready to sell.
Customer coming up.
I'm stacked.
You sell out of necessity. It's definitely not a dream job. I would agree with you in saying that drug dealers are not doing it as a dream job, but saying that drug dealers are selling drugs out of necessity is not always true. There are a lot of drug dealers, especially higher up drug dealers, that are pushing like weight instead of individually selling on the corner. They're making hundreds of thousands of dollars. They're not doing it out of necessity. They're doing it because they're making a shitload of money. Like, it depends on the drug dealer. If you're saying it's an individual corner dealer, yeah, they might do it for the money. But, or, like, because they need it. But if you're talking about, like, higher ups, yeah, like Gustavo from Breaking Bad, he's making millions of dollars. A little swammy for the sub.
Well, for the group, can I see some tattoos?
Oh, if four doesn't have tats, I lose. If four doesn't have tattoos, I'm out.
This is Al Capone in the shootout, the police. This is more personal stuff, you know? I got my whole stomach.
Oh my God, dude, he's tattooed everywhere.
You have any tattoos? Number one?
Not that I can show.
We'd like to make an elimination.
Ooh!
Eliminated number one because
SpongeBob and his collar. He is not from the 80s.
Yeah, he does kind of. He looks like he's trying to like dress a part of like an old gangster.
Did he dress like that?
This is questions for number five. Have you ever been robbed?
Have I ever been robbed? Yeah, I think we all have. It just comes with the game.
Oh, shit. What area do you guys stay in, like, right now?
Downtown L.A.
Downtown?
Orange County.
Orange County.
South Central.
South Central.
Downtown L.A.
Downtown.
South Central.
K-Town.
K-Town.
Nah, dude, maybe, bro, come on. Bro, come on, dude, it might be the guy in the back. Oh, my chat might have known. My chat might have been smart with that shit. Oh, it's probably him. It's probably him, isn't it?
Number one. Do you know any weight conversions?
It's kilos. Kilos of pounds.
Number three, do you know any weight conversions?
Basis, grams, pounds, ounces, QPs, birds, that type of
All right,
I hate him too! Dude, to know that shit, no one knows that shit.
Number four, did you ever have to flush anything down the toilet?
Nah.
Nah?
They should have asked a base drug question. Just to immediately eliminate people. How much is an eighth? How much is an eighth in grams? If they don't get that right, then it's not them.
Anybody have any nicknames?
Certain places they call me Medusa.
Medusa.
T-Mac.
Called Chunk.
Chunk.
Roach.
Roach. All right. We're ready to eliminate some people. I mean, somebody.
Ah, dude, it has to be the old guy in the back. Cause especially, dude. How he looks at the camera. Oh my God, it's him. Oh my God, it's him. Just like that old style, like. Like, try, bro. Because he said he hasn't been selling drugs in forever. It's him. It's him. It's the guy in the back. I lost. I already know I lost.
Oh, number two was more of a raver than a drug dealer.
They're giving me tattoo artists.
For the group. Finish this segment. Never get
up.
Chat.
High off your own supply.
That's what I was gonna say.
Never spend your bread on your own supply.
Yeah, never take your own
Number three.
Never get high on your own supply. Isn't that in Breaking Bad? Sesky for the sub.
Can I see the way
Yo, Lamone, shut up. Lamone, I get it, okay? You keep spamming that it's you. I'm just letting you know, man. Settle down.
Fuck, bro. Can I just see it?
Strut for us.
You're strut. Yeah, being from the block
rude.
To the bag.
That was a bit rude, Lamone. I'm sorry, but you've been spamming that shit.
Yeah, we look for those kind of walks and that kind of style.
Dude, the socks, though, bro, it makes me think it's him. Dude, the just the whole. Oh, my God. Oh, and just he knew his shit too.
That's a mean one. Okay, yo. OG.
All day.
Okay.
All day.
For the it's group. In Scarface.
Again, how'd you get in the game?
Oh, my flight instructor was a drug smuggler, and he just took me to the side. He's like, "Hey, Ray, you know what? You're a good pilot. Why don't you become a drug smuggler? See the airplane out there? Every time you bring it back, you're gonna make 60 to 80,000 per flight." So I did it.
I first moved to Orange County. Everyone at my high school was doing Zans, and I was the only kid in Orange County with no money, so I wanted some money, and they said, this is how you can get it.
Well, y'all know in the hood, we don't got much to start with, so just being from gangs in the hood and the older homies coming up to you, letting you know here's a way to make some money.
My uncle had me deliver shit and told me what it was, take this money.
I lost my college wrestling scholarship. Moved back home, found out my
It's not him! It can't be him. It's the dude in the back at three. I kind of want to stick to my guns, though, and say that it's number four.
I was f***ing a coke dealer. What did I do? I took the same route he did. I wanted to do it better.
We'd like
Oh, and I hate how he's chewing his gum, though. Do y'all chew your gum with your mouth open? Bio for the sub, Sesky for the sub. I already said that. A little spammy for the sub. I chew my gum, you just go. Like, sometimes, like, every once in a while if you're moving it, but, like, I'm not chewing that shit with my mouth wide open.
Another elimination, please. Okay. His answers.
Wow! Chat!
Were so, like, they were so on point that they sounded fake.
Also, when we asked him what was white, he said, the man? I was like,
the question we have is for number 6. Do you know what a dub is?
A dub?
Like, somebody be like, oh, let me get a dub.
I don't.
Let's see, number 5. Can you name a class A, B, or C drug?
Well, I could tell you right now, testosterone and steroids are under the same category as marijuana and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. If you get caught selling steroids, you got 3 to 5 year sentence.
I didn't know that.
Great information.
No, just in case y'all ever need to know.
I don't know if I asked this already.
What's crazy to me is state laws. Like, in New Jersey, weed's legal. Like, when I'm 21, I can smoke weed on stream. But if I walked over to Pennsylvania and I got caught with weed, I would go to jail for 5 years. Like, is it that nuts? Like, it's just like state law. Like, literally the second you walk over, like, 5 years in prison. But then when you're in New Jersey, that's fine. You can just smoke it. Like, nobody cares. Like, nobody cares.
But everybody's occupation.
I'm a performer.
Performer? 3.
Aspiring actor.
Yeah?
No, see, nah, he hesitated on that answer. Aspiring actor. Maybe it's not him. Maybe he actually is just an aspiring actor.
Hey. I'm a
he's acting the part.
Real chill.
That's for sure. I see Magic Mike. I'm going to do a little action. I just want to know if anybody knows what this is. Like, say, like, you know, you don't have, like, a scale or something like that. You know, you want to weigh something, like... Anybody know what this is called? You
gotta eye it.
Number 3 is doing it.
We want to eliminate somebody.
Oh, chat! Yo, you might have lost there, chat. Hold that. I'm not definite on this because I could be wrong, but hold that shit. For right now, hold that L, right? You might revoke that L in a second. I might have to hold that L. I'm probably going to have to hold that L, seeing that it's probably not number 4. But you guys got to hold that L, too.
Drug dealer number 6. Unfortunately, both teams have decided that you are not the real deal. And we are going to have you exit, please.
You wait.
It's not him! Bro, he just broke character.
Two, what's white?
Cocaine.
What's white?
Cocaine.
Number 4, what's white?
Coke.
Number 1, what's white?
Cocaine and cocaine accessories.
Now, the way this guy talks in the front, though, bro, he's so quiet. It's not him.
Number 3, what's white?
Coke.
Okay, so time has run out for y'all. If you want to go ahead and just make your final guess.
I don't think it is, but if you say no, bro.
If I'm right on 4, I'm a fucking genius.
I know for sure it's not.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right. For the whole entire group, do you know the difference between indica, sativa, and hybrid?
Hell yeah.
Number 1.
Yes, that's
it's actually a myth, by the way. Indica, sativa, hybrid. Hybrid is a mixture of indica and sativa. Indica makes you tired and sleepy. Sativa makes you energetic, and it's more of a head high. That's actually cap. It's kind of a marketing scheme. It's actually the difference in the length of the weed strain. College teaches you some things, chat. Somebody redeemed show headset, Dan. How do you know that? Damn, I don't know.
You don't?
No.
Number 2.
Indica is more like a downer, kind of chill. Sativa.
It's also basic info. It's not that crazy that I know that, by the way. But no, it's generally in reference to the length of the strain. Or not the length of the strain. It's indica and sativa are generally just like the lengths. But it's generally associated with like sativa head high, indica you get like tired. But that's kind of a myth. It's actually like the terpenes and other shit in the, I think it's called terpenes. Is it called terpenes? Yeah, the terpenes. The terpenes in the weed and some other shit actually change how the high is comparative.
It's more like happy, let's get going, and hybrid is kind of...
Where do you get weed? In New Jersey, you can buy weed at a dispensary. It's like walking into like a store.
Good mix of both. It depends on what it's mixed with, if it's a hybrid dominant or sativa dominant.
You got a little bit of gelato 33, you got, there you go. You got something to switch you to bed, you know, sativa, you just the opposite, you got some lemon haze, you got something like that.
Number three.
See, but like, that's not proving that he's a drug dealer, that might just prove that he smoked weed before.
With someone that
Like stoner info. That's like, oh, you smoke. That's not, oh, you sell drugs.
Like clear addictions.
Meaning that was obvious?
Yeah. Yeah. And you still sell to them?
Yeah. Okay, it was a cutthroat business, man. And then couldn't care about none of that.
Number three, what are you doing in the morning?
Wake and bake. search for some acting jobs.
Number five, what are you doing in the morning?
I'm up at 6 a.m. with my morning blunt, going to see my trainer.
Bro wakes up at 6 a.m. and smokes weed. Jesus.
I'll say it together. Officially.
We're ready to lock in. Well.
Together.
Oh, okay.
Officially, we're.
Oh. Okay.
They're high right now. They're. They're high right now. They're high in this video. Like right now, they're high.
Officially, we're ready to lock in.
Are y'all high right now?
Oh, yeah.
Their eyes are glossy too. You can see when your eyes glare better, like that. Like if you look at my eyes right now, they're just kind of there. But like you see how theirs are much more reflective.
You just got
that, or if they're red, obviously.
Yeah, I need something to mellow me out.
One, three, and five. I think it's three or four.
Stoners have officially locked in their real deal, which means the game is over.
All right, we think the real deal is number.
Number two? No shot, it's number two.
They know too much about drugs.
Either a user or a seller.
We think the real deal is number three.
Bro, nobody picked who I picked. Fuck.
Everything he was doing, we're either getting bamboozled or he's really, you know, doing what he says he does.
If the lights on your podium turn green, that means you have chosen the real deal. If they turn red, that means that you have chosen an imposter. Law enforcement, your guess was former drug dealer number two. In three, two,
they're wrong, bro. It's not two. Yeah.
What?
Motherfucker. The cops got it wrong. Oh, bro. Damn, the stoners get it right.
It was the stripper, huh?
Yeah. I'm pissed.
I'm just a little mad, a little disappointed because I second-guessed myself.
For our stoner team, you have chosen former drug dealer number three.
Let's see.
Bro, I want it to be four. I want it to be four, three, just so I'm right. But three seemed
two,
like he knew the most.
One.
Oh. Yeah! Fuck. It was death, yo. Okay. Okay. I'll hold the L. I'll hold the L there. I'll hold the L there. I'll hold the L there. I'll hold the L. Okay. 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 All right. That's fair. That's fair. That's fair. He did know his shit. And dude, they immediately... If the cops, yo, I don't want to be that guy. If the cops followed their initial judgment in how high somebody's socks were, they would have just immediately knew it was him. like I feel like he was probably like, oh shit, when they fucking said that.
I'm sorry that we ran out. I'm sorry that we ran out. They so we good. Do. Hello, everybody. I'm Tyrone, and I am the real deal. After getting arrested a number of times and watching friends get killed and things of that nature,
wow.
I was trying to find a way out. And the best way to get out of that type of life is you have to take yourself out of the environment.
Leaving California is really what made me change.
We won this for the Stoners.
We did that. Mm-hmm.
What did we learn in today's game?
And the cops lost. Bro, the fucking Stoners got it right, and the cops are sitting there all sad.
We learned that the higher the socks, the downer the fool. It comes down to that today.
They said that in the beginning.
So besides being a former drug dealer, what were you also?
Law enforcement.
Oh, what a twist.
This is a Jordan.
He was a drug dealer and a cop? That's the biggest plot twist ever.
I thought he was.
Wow, bro was a fucking cop and a drug dealer. Holy shit. You would never expect that twist. Holy fuck. All right. I need to take a piss. So we're going to play some funk music, and I'm going to go to the bathroom, and you guys are going to count me down 30 seconds. Count me down 30 seconds. Oh my god, the hair sticking up in the back of the head. We're back! Y'all ready for the next video? Alright, I'll let you guys choose. We got three videos left, right? We got a few short ones, a few long ones. Alright, first video, Bill Nye goes sneaker shopping. Second video, banned GameStop training video. Third, OnlyFans pimps are delusional. Which do we watch first? We're going to watch all three. One, two, or three. Vote. One, two, three. One, two, three. You guys vote. Bill Nye goes sneaker shopping, I feel, is going to be a fucking banger. Like, what the fuck is Bill Nye going to buy in terms of drip? You know what I mean? Okay, everybody's voting one. Everybody's voting one, so we're going to watch one first. Bill Nye goes sneaker shopping. This is going to be insane. Literally. Bro, okay, whatever. $350 for those fucking whistle shoes. Those are the ugliest shoes ever. Dude, that looks like wood. That looks like plywood. $400! Dude, you could have bought... Oh my god, you could have bought a pair of Jordan 1s. Instead, you bought the Kith X New Balance 992 Kith Miss Red. Oh, for $400, dude. You bought $400 New Balances over a pair of Jordan 1s. That is absurd to me. That is absurd to me. Oh my god. Dude, I need to see the comments. I need to see the comments. The fact that he's famous because every science teacher in America used to play his videos is pretty dope. Bill immediately hits the New Balance section dead face. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Fucking exactly, dude. Respect Bill, but the New Balance section, bro, come on. You can never go wrong with New Balances. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. They're great running shoes. They are the ugliest shoes I've ever seen, though. All right, we got two more videos. We got two more fucking videos. We're going to do a poll here, chat. One or two, which do we watch first? Which one is the GameStop video? Two is the OnlyFans pimps are delusional. Which one do we watch first? People are still the it's a bit even of a poll here. Bit even of a poll. Started the poll here. Got to vote. Which one? I got to check my TikTok, actually. I posted while people vote here. Oh, community guideline violation. Woo! Dub in the chat, baby. Dub in the chat. Harassment and bullying. It was literally just a fucking video. Oh, my God. Disagree. This did not violate community guidelines. Appeal. Woo! Love when they take down my shit for no fucking reason. Love it. All right. People have voted two. Let's watch two first. This is Gunner TV. I've shouted him out in the past. I fucking love Gunner's videos. Already going to like the video before I even fucking watch it. Sub to Gunner TV. OnlyFans pimps are delusional.
OnlyFans.
Hey, who the hell are you? I'm leaving.
I'm going. I'm sorry.
Gross.
Goddamn squatters. OnlyFans, a platform where creators and celebrities can sell exclusive content to their fans for a simple monthly subscription fee. Said content might range from the innocuous swimsuit pic all the way to incredibly specific pornographic videos involving human feet.
Dirty Feet Girl 92.
I'm sure many would regard as sacrilegious.
I feel like I should scan this video. Now we're chilling. Didn't Moist Critical do an OnlyFans for feet? Somebody told me that. Moist Critical OnlyFans feet. Okay, well, this is going to ruin my search history. One of my chatters told me that. That might have been the biggest lie of all time. How is my OnlyFans going? Okay, no, he did make an OnlyFans. He made an OnlyFans. He did make an OnlyFans in 2021. He made a feet OnlyFans. Okay, he did. Nobody was lying.
Not that I've seen those videos.
Does Joe have an OnlyFans? Yeah, fuck no.
Whatever you're following or whatever you're looking for on OnlyFans, it's almost always the case to be somewhat sexual in nature. Which is why it was very strange when the company made the decision to ban all sexual content on the platform this time last year. A policy reversed in only 6 days after everyone universally said, "You sure about that?" But today, OnlyFans is thriving, with stats showing users spending some $4.8 billion on the site in the last year alone. And of course, in any profitable marketplace,
OnlyFans makes $4.8 billion a year?
Selling an honest product or service, there will always be 20-something-year-old dude bros looking to make money off of it without all that gross, icky work stuff. Enter the douchiest OnlyFans pimps on this side of the Miami River. Closer Look Agency.
Hov, you dropped out of college with your best friend and became millionaires by 22. Course coming soon.
These two super cool guys are named Spencer McManus and Grant Ganley, and they co-own an OnlyFans agency together that takes a cut from OnlyFans creators in exchange for growing their accounts. And may I just point out what Alpha Chad last names these two have, McManus and Ganley? No fake middle names needed here, Jeremiah Bowl Evans. These two have built-in natural warrior title names.
McManus and Ganley. Well, that's Gideon.
Make me want to change my own to something cooler, like Gunner Gargantuan. Yeah, that has a nice ring to it. Anyway, Spencer and Grant make a lot of money stealing from women on OnlyFans. I'm sorry, I meant managing women on OnlyFans. Now I can't see their financial.
Well, every OnlyFans creator does have management. Little insider knowledge from the TikTokers I know that do OnlyFans. They've told me that they don't even manage, like, any TikToker you know that runs an OnlyFans, they don't manage it. So if like you sub to somebody's OnlyFans and they like contact, like that you're messaging them or some shit, you're not messaging them. You're messaging some random dude that's managing the OnlyFans and convincing you that they're them. Just because it's like for a big TikTok creator that has a massive OnlyFans following to sit there and individually message hundreds of people, is not possible or worth their time. So they pay somebody like a 5% cut. Which is what they might be doing, but it seems like they're doing it in a worser fashion. How do you know of this? Because the creators tell me. I love how people say, how do you know this? Like me subbing to an OnlyFans would make me know that, when in reality, that would not help me at all. Me knowing that is only possible if an OnlyFans creator told me that. So you saying, how do you know this, is not an, oh, you sub to an OnlyFans. No, it's literally they told me. That would be the only way.
Well, I can't say for sure.
Like, let's just think logically here.
millionaires or not, but boy, do they like to tell us they are with constant...
Oh, this is a permaban. Yeah, that's a permaban. That's a permaban. That's a permaban. That's an insta-permaban. Yep, there we are. There we are. Banned. Nah, banned. That. Nah, banned. Banned. Yeah, no shot. Imagine if Brooke made an OnlyFans. I mean, dude, I'd support with whatever the fuck she would want to do, but yeah, bro's trying to be fucking creepy about it. Brax for the 300 bits. What would you do if Brooke made an OnlyFans? Okay, now, dude, I would support her, but I mean, like, I'm not going to be in the fucking video, so I'm not, I ain't going to be, she ain't doing anything, I wouldn't support her doing anything with anybody else, but if it was like she just wanted to make one, whatever, but I mean, she's not going to.
Flexing on their socials, often showing their table at the club, their fancy sports cars, or for some reason their money counting machine. Don't know why you need that. Isn't your entire business online? Why is there cash involved? You know, you're
so
not-
when you text an OnlyFans creator, you're not actually talking to them, you're just talking to a dude and telling them how horny you are. Yes, you, if you ever message dude, OnlyFans, like, I'm gonna keep it real, never buy an OnlyFans. Like, what is the fucking purpose of buying an OnlyFans? You're paying to see somebody naked? Like, why? Like, what is the purpose there? And hey, like, I know a lot of creators that do OnlyFans. Yeah, good shit for them for making money, but like, there's no point. There's no point. And it makes no sense.
Not actually pimps, right? Oh no, they don't know that. Oh, I see the problem now.
Yo, Spence, why do you have a third phone? People just don't do that.
It's simple, really. I'm not fucking people.
Oh shit.
Brrr. The problem now.
Yo, Spence, why do you have a third phone? People just don't do that.
It's simple, really. I'm not fucking people.
Oh, dude, they're gonna be broke in a year. They're gonna be broke in a year. That's like, so, number one, financially irresponsible. Number two, like, what the fuck are you buying? What are those ugly ass fucking glasses? Because I'm not people. I buy $3,000 iPhones because I just can. What's the point? You're just not using the other two.
Do that.
It's simple, really.
Like, having two phones is useful in some scenarios, but, like, three? What the fuck are you doing?
I'm not fucking
blocky-ass glasses. Literally, bro, looks like a Minecraft character with those glasses on.
Oh, really? I'm not fucking people.
Oh, shit.
Aren't those literally the Minecraft glasses? Those literally looked like the Minecraft glasses.
Simple, really. I'm not fucking people.
Oh, shit.
Brrr. Are we in the Arctic? That was the coldest thing I've ever seen.
Simple, really. I'm not fucking people.
I'm not fucking people,
all right? Well, I mean, I am fucking people. I do fuck. I'm not fucking people. I'm not those people. I'm not those fucking people. I'm not fucking people. Grant, can we reshoot it? And I love how this girl just comes in the frame like he just spawned her there because of this sick one-liner. Hey, let's get out of here, babe.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, right there, that's good. So, you know, I walk in, I see my $100 bill, remind myself how rich I am, and also can see my best...
Oh! Oh!
See my $100 bill,
see how rich I am? Oh, that's so fucking cringe. That's, like, actually so annoying.
How rich I am, and also can see my best friend and my business partner, Grant, right there. It looks good, my man. Thank you. Chef, what we got for you today?
So, Mr. Spence, so today we got some Wagyu. We're gonna make
That is just a random kid. That is not a chef. There is no shot that, oh, what's going on? We have some Wagyu today. Dude, this kid's, like, 19. This kid is my age. This kid's, like, 20 years old. He is not a fucking professional chef. You do not hire this man to stay at your house and cook for you. There's no fucking shot.
Inspired.
Says Ross for the 300 bits. Good mythical morning. Finn awake and bake. W stream as always. It's not morning. It's fucking 6 p.m. Zesty for the 3,000 bits. Or not 3,000 bits. 300 bits.
Man. Appreciate you.
A look into a piece of my day living as a millionaire in Miami. Yep, supernatural day in the life of a millionaire. Just happened to be caught on camera. This is definitely how millionaires talk and interact with people. Picture hanging guy, because that's a job I can't be bothered to do. That's perfect. Right next to the $100 drop shipped Etsy canvas to remind myself I'm a piece of shit. And this one, because that's my best friend and business partner, Grant. I love him in our snuggles. Hey, chef, what's cooking? Wagyu? It better only be from those newborn baby cows that suffer greatly. You know that's how I like it. The flexing doesn't stop there. It's their entire pages. But there's something so funny about the fact that while they seem desperate to portray themselves as tough macho thugs, their entire business at the end of the day is social media growth for OnlyFans girls, something you never actually have to leave your home to do. Yet they flex in the douchiest way possible, as if they're a GTA character running the city. 3 years ago, I had a dream. I ran the biggest OnlyFans agency in the world. Okay. Did you achieve it? This B-roll isn't really proof. It's just kind of you on a boat with some girl.
You're like, how rich do you think these guys actually are? Like, I feel like they're not lying that they make money, but any account that flaunts, I'm rich, I'm this, I'm that, like, it's, yeah, and those are $1 bills. Yeah, those are $1 bills, and it's just also, like, every account that flaunts their money, they may have money, but it's definitely way less than they portray it as.
Wasting singles as they're surely going into the water behind you. Something you might have noticed so far about these boys is that they're huge Andrew Tate fans. Shocking news that no one saw coming. This information has rattled me to my core. Oh, look at them smoking cigars and sipping.
Yeah, this looks like they're trying to like actually just copy Andrew Tate. Like smoking a cigar, whatever, but like the whole background, how they're sitting, them with the sunglasses on inside. Like, what the fuck are you doing?
Rocks while wearing shades indoors. That's so their own personality. We're like Batman and Robin, but we scale OnlyFans creators' pages. So nothing like Batman and Robin. Except there's two of you, I guess. And maybe one of you calls the other daddy from time to time. Here's a POV of Grant pretending he knows how to play chess, because that's something Tate's also good at. And surprise, surprise, you go to their TikTok pages and they're giving the same delusional, ego-driven takes as if Andrew Tate is physically in their tiny little brains, pulling tiny levers around to speak through them.
Hey brother, saw your TikTok about getting money. How easy is it? Well, I mean, for me, life's been pretty fucking easy. I'm 6'3", I'm jacked.
All right, buddy. Fucking relax you. For me, life is pretty easy. You know, I'm 6'3", I'm fucking jacked. I promote OnlyFans. My success is through women, not from my own success. It's through managing accounts. Actually, I DM men that are really horny, and they tell me that they want to see the woman, and they think they're talking to the woman, but they're actually talking to me. And so I'm kind of like the middleman, and yeah, no.
I'm obviously good looking, as you guys can see. I'm already at 7 figures and I'm 24. I really haven't been doing this that long. Picked the most fun career. I'm not a nerd. I'm not going to sit there at a computer all day. I don't code. I don't do anything. You know, I just look good for the cameras. I do my thing. I scale businesses.
You don't look good for the cameras. You're not in the camera. You're just fucking doing this to try and promote your own business. And probably a fucking other program too on financial success. You're not in the camera. If your business is literally just management of OnlyFans, you're not the camera. Your clients are the camera. You're just a management agency for fucking OnlyFans. Bravo.
And I work with really pretty women. So, you know, for me, it's really easy. You know, for you guys, the plebs, the plebeians.
The plebs, the plebeians, right. Yeah, those are words you use often. Sure. And nothing exudes more confidence than incredibly shifty eye contact while you boast about your achievements.
I'm 6'3", I'm jacked.
Yeah, that is true. He's kind of just like looking around.
I'm obviously good looking.
Obviously good looking? Calm down, ROTC. What's great is you can really tell.
I just snorted. The fucking ROTC roast. Pickle for the sub, another for the three. Moving to Saudi Arabia from Germany next week. Wish me luck. Damn, it's probably going to be way fucking hotter there. Have fun.
Hell, he's just being himself here, and I love that for him.
Good luck.
That's a joke. This is worse acting than amateur porn. How ironic. Want to be Tate so bad. Who? Nice cover-up, Grant. Pretend you don't know who that is. Who? I've never heard of this Tate person or object. I mean, are you talking about a small wrinkly fruit? Do you mean a date? What is a Tate? Sorry, I blacked out for a moment there. I went too deep in the character. LMAO, Tate Wannabe, and he replies the facepalm emoji, like
dude, I want to look him up. Dude, I just feel like you're not making that much. Like, they might be making, like, good money, but it's definitely not, like, they're not making, like, $40 million a year money. What is their fucking name? Grant Ganley. Grant Ganley. It's not even going to show up. Oh, it does show up. He has 1 million followers. Oh, he just posts literally the fucking... He posts the fucking pics. Oh, he has like 10 pictures on his Instagram. He has literally like 10 pictures on his fucking Instagram. This is it. It's with the boys, smoking a cigar, standing with Bradley Martin. That is actually a pic. How many likes does it have? You can't even see. It won't even show me. Okay. You think those are 1 million real followers? I always get sussed out by Instagram accounts. The biggest fake account area is Instagram followers. I'm not saying they are fake, but...
Like, if
somebody has a botted account, it's on Instagram. And 9 times out of 10, if your account's botted for followers, it's Instagram.
Like, oh, you're so stupid. No. But then go only a month back in his TikToks, and he'll tell you straight up, these EMFs to look up to. Who is that? Did my account get hacked? I do not remember posting this. Or we could take a look at another Spencer McManus TikTok where he outright quotes Tate.
You need to get jacked. Look, before I knew how to make any fucking money, first thing I did was I got jacked. What did this do? I used to push carts at the supermarket. I used to work at Moe's Southwest Grill.
I don't like, you know, it's more so, like, I'm not doubting that these guys made a successful business, right? But at some point, you have to admit when luck is in your favor. I don't like when a lot of successful people will just claim that it's solely them, right? I'll say, yeah, I am very consistent on social media, and I'm proud of myself for that. But my initial launch on social media was in part luck. And it's the same thing for businesses, right? Like, him saying, like, oh, he's all self-built, it's all this, it's all that. Like, that may be true that you put in the hours, but, like, being successful in life is more so taking advantage of lucky opportunities. And, like, bravo for you doing that, but let's settle down here and say that, like, you're some jacked guy that, like, is a multimillionaire solely for yourself and that you built yourself and nobody, and you could have just reset. If I reset and you just had to fucking start from square one again, you would build all the way back up, no problem. Like, let's settle down from that, okay?
Cleaning fucking bathrooms.
Like, yeah, you might have some sort of success because you have knowledge. Like, I believe, yeah, like, if I didn't have, like, an initial lucky boost, I still could have grown on social media. But in part, my growth on social media was initially luck. Your initial growth on anything is usually just circumstance.
Like a loser. But physically, I was stronger, bigger, more vascular, and better than my bosses and everybody that I used to fucking work with. So why would I push carts and make minimum wage like a scrub while the guy ahead of me, who was still a scrub, right, but he's a supervisor, made more money than me? Tate says it very well, right? Strong body, strong mind. You psychologically think that you're better than these people and you think that you deserve to make more money than them, which is true, right?
First off, why is there a stack of cash in front of you? Are we doing a deal? Second, what dumbass will quote Tate for strong body, strong mind? That proverb's been around for centuries. Third, you didn't even extract the right meaning from it and use it as justification to think you're better than people because you can lift heavy
bars. Yeah, you shouldn't say you're better. You're not, just because you're more rich than someone, you're not better than someone. Having more money at the end of the day in the meaning of life is valueless, right? In today's society, money is everything. But in terms of, like, you're going to die one day, money is worthless, right? Your money's not carrying over. It's not doing anything, right? What really matters is, like, changing people's lives and shit like that in terms of, like, your actual gravitation on the fucking world. So you sitting here and saying you're better than everybody because you make more money is just, you seem like a fucking idiot. Coupled with the fact that you... The people pushing carts, you're saying, oh, I'm better than all these cart pushers. A lot of people just don't have the opportunity, right? And I understand everybody's going to have an opportunity one day, and it's your job to capitalize on that. And yes, if you do want to be successful, you have to put in the hours. But, like, let's settle down here and stop acting like you're just a fucking genius.
Up and down.
You psychologically think that you're better than these people and you think that you deserve to make more money than them, which is true.
I think it's pretty obvious that they're bandwagoning off of Tate deliberately. But was the goal to get bullied by someone like me online for attention, or did they actually just become tiny Tates because they can't think for themselves? Both explanations are pretty sad and pathetic to think about, but if your goal was attention, congrats, you got it. How's your soul doing? Are you empty inside? With the spotlight on you now, I'll do my best to metaphorically pelt tomatoes at you during your performance because Lord knows you deserve it. So let's take a close closer look at Closer Look Agency, their OnlyFans business that he just claimed was super easy for him.
Saw your TikTok about getting money. How easy is it? Well, I mean, for me, life's been pretty fucking easy.
But then post other TikToks that make it seem like it was actually a really hard grind to the top. Everyone sees the final result, but not what it took to get there. Wow. I mean,
not what it took to get there was how to understanding Wall Street, the market, the stock market. I thought you made your money from a fucking OnlyFans agency. Why are all these books about the fucking stock market?
Those books.
You didn't read any of those goddamn books.
And pictures of your computer with stock graphs, you're really putting those reps in. And while they'll inevitably make a course charging Nelkboy fans thousands of dollars to learn the business, I can break down their strategy for free.
Oh, they are selling a business. Oh, they're selling the fucking business idea. Oh, God. It's another fucking cookie cutter program, how to get rich quick. You only have to give me $675 and I'll give you a get rich quick. And then their point is always this. Why pay for college? 30 grand? 100 grand? $675 to the Vart man. A hundred grand to college? $675. Let's weigh the options here. Which one's going to be more successful? Which one costs more cost effective? Yeah, you're also selling me a shilled fucking program that's actually useless. And you could have learned by fucking Googling shit.
Three simple steps. One, credibility. Two, acquisition.
Are you going to take the red pill? Are you going to take the blue pill? College? Or are you going to buy my program and become rich? And they always use like, yes, yes, okay? Yes, say 1,000 people buy your fucking program. 2 of them might get successful from it. The other 998 people are going to be fucking dead broke down $675 because they bought your shit.
3, marketing. Welcome to Business 101.
And I'm not advocating for college either. I'm a college student. I can see where college is useless in a lot of ways. It's also useful in a lot of ways. It depends on the person. But trying to compare college to a fucking shitty-ass pyramid scheme program, how to get rich quick, so fucking stupid.
I'm your professor, Gunnar Gargantuan. If you expect to make it in this industry, you can't be a nobody. Well, actually you can, but you have to make it look like you're not. I'll let Spencer explain.
I bought a McLaren when I was 21. Why did I do that? Somebody messages me about let's work, let's do business. I look at their profile and they don't have a fucking supercar or they look like they're not up. Like, I will never respond to that message. And it's just human.
Dude, that's so dumb though. You're giving bad advice. You get stacks when you're young? Fucking compound that shit. If you get rich quick when you're young, that's fucking great news for you. Because then you can fucking compound that money better than somebody that gets rich when they're 45 years old. Getting rich and spending your money on a fucking $1 million McLaren when you're fucking 21 is the dumbest idea that you could fucking possibly do. Yes, you want to spend your money and not fucking live a boring life, but at least save some of it.
Psychology. It's nothing about being disrespectful or it's nothing about like...
I wouldn't do business with somebody that didn't own a McLaren. What a dumb fucking statement.
Not talking to somebody or because they look poor. It has nothing to do with that, but you just gotta to realize that's the way that the world works.
Okay, step one, students, and I want you to write this down. After you leave class today, you're immediately going to go out and purchase a supercar. How do you expect anyone to want to do business with you if you're not up? Of course, in actuality, you will be down hundreds of thousands of dollars in debt, but we're gonna make
yeah,
that
by leasing a sports car. Let me go out and lease a McLaren. What a, if you have the fucking gall to go and lease a McLaren, you are out of your fucking mind.
Okay.
I was able to sign hundreds and hundreds of clients, close hundreds and hundreds of deals because I had the car as a testimonial, a proof of my worth as an entrepreneur. I've earned this. I know how to make money.
You gotta spend money to make money. That's just good business. Hold up. Looking back at the flexing now, are they currently successful or was this just step one of the plan? I had to find out, so I started looking around for clues and I stumbled upon a lead when I saw this TikTok on Spencer's second page, McManus Wisdom.
I really just bought the penthouse at the age of 23.
What do you do?
A simple claim, really. Not too much to work with. Yeah, wrong. Dead wrong you'd be, as you forgot my old job before Moist Critical gave me my entire YouTube career. Bless up, Charlie. You can name my firstborn. But I was a real estate agent, specifically in Miami, and I recognize this building. I won't dox the man and say the name of it, but here's footage from their website. You can see the two towers with a conjoined bridge, the pool and hot tub layout are the same. And in his other TikTok, where he claims the unit is worth $5 million and strangely refers to himself in the third person, you can see the metro rail running below it just as it does here. So what, Gunner? You figured out where he lives. Pretty creepy video segment. On the contrary, it's still kind of creepy.
Oh, is he gonna fucking say the price, bro?
Important, because I'm pretty sure this building only does rentals.
Please hold while I try to connect you. Thank you for calling Miami. Julie speaking.
Bro, do you think they lease their sports cars? No shot. No shot they lease a McLaren. Dude, how much is leasing a McLaren? That has to be absurdly expensive.
Hi, Julie. This is Gunnar Gargantuan. I had a quick question. I saw someone online say that they bought the penthouse unit in the North Tower for $5 million. But I had a quick question. Are you guys only rentals or do you guys also sell units?
We don't sell units. That's a total lie.
Okay. All right.
The unit is still on the market right now for rent.
Okay. I just wanted to double check that. I figured. Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Shocked, betrayed, devastated I was. Them telling us to buy supercars and they can't even afford to purchase a penthouse? Pff, fucking plebs.
The best thing you got.
It's creepy that he doxed him, though. It's weird to care that much. Not if you're like, he literally, I don't think that's creepy that Gunner, that's not even doxing. It's a rental property where they probably don't even live. They just use it to film. Because, and you're also, if you're filming a video on your balcony, where you're fucking broadcasting the entire city, that's not even really that hard to find where they are. Like, if you post a video right here, like, someone's going to be able to find out what building. You know what I mean? Like, if you're on the top building, that's not doxing. Like, if you're on the top building and you're broadcasting, I bought this penthouse, you could just kind of be like, oh, yeah, that's right here. I know this sit. This is Miami. This is that building. That's the penthouse. Boom. How much does that cost? And if they're renting it, they're not using it. They probably rented it for like a month, filmed videos in it, and then ditched it.
Complebs?
The best thing you guys should know is when you go to manage someone, you need credibility.
I will agree with you. Yeah, maybe it's a little bit odd, but like, I mean, Gunner wasn't doing that to be like, oh, fuck you. Gunner was doing that to prove the point that they didn't actually buy the house because you can't buy it. It's a rental.
And so that's what school does. You know,
like, genuine doxing is creepy. Like, genuine doxing is creepy, but that's not even doxing. He didn't release the address. He didn't say anything about it. He bleeped everything out, too. He was just like, oh, I used to be a retail agent in that city. I know where that building is. Let me call them and ask them if it's a rental. That's not doxing.
Graduate gives you the illusion of credibility. So that's what you're going to do to this one.
So the illusion of credibility is what we're after. Got it. Like your accounts being fake verified with artificial likes and views like that? Like, is that what we're talking about? For those of you that don't know, it's actually pretty easy to get verified on TikTok or Instagram if you have about $10,000 burning a hole in your pocket. It used to be you pay for a few fake articles about you online and boom, blue check mark. But Instagram caught on. YouTuber Spencer Cornelia just did a great video about this, but the most recent scheme was to pretend to be a musical artist on Spotify and pay for artificial listens like Spencer and Grant did. Spencer had hit songs such as Savage Society, War With Us, and Internet Money, classics. I'm personally a bigger fan of Grant's music with his songs GG's, Internet Mafia, and my favorite, the Pimpin' Ain't Easy remix. I don't know what they're remixing. I must have missed the original Pimpin' Ain't Easy. Now, they do have to submit...
Dude, I want
to
listen to that. Should we listen to that?
...hit real songs to Spotify, but they don't have to be good. Mostly just shitty garage band beats they pay someone on Fiverr to make in 5 minutes. Here, I'm going to read Grant's Spotify bio while I play the Pimpin' Ain't Easy remix. Grant Ganley manages to keep churning out one hit after another without fail or fatigue. The musical genius answers that when you truly love and are passionate about what you do, everything else just falls into place by itself. Another wholly fascinating quality about Grant Ganley music is that it's unique yet something that anyone from any walk of life can relate to. His music transcends all boundaries of time, distance, and language and touches hearts in the remotest
boundaries
of the world
of time.
As people hum and groove to his beats, captivated by their haunting depth and beauty. Truly poetic
It's
stuff.
Just a fucking beat.
I almost shed a tear reading that one. So you got the sports car, the penthouse, and now you're verified. What's the next step, Professor? You're going to need to start reaching out to OnlyFans creators and signing them on to your agency. Typically, this is done through DM outreach and setting up calls, but a little TikTok advertising couldn't hurt. So this is where the flexing comes into play. Show your future clients that this is the lifestyle you lead and that you know what you're doing. Join the family. Aww, what a precious way of saying we're going to need to see you naked on camera. Most people are grown-ups and they can make their own decisions on which businesses they choose to do or not. But it's a bit weird to be specifically searching out women that are
on TikTok too,
currently working 9-to-5 jobs and not the women already on OnlyFans. They also
so they're trying to convince it. It's more like they're like trying to bottom feed this shit. They're not reaching out to already made OnlyFans creators. They're trying to get people to get on OnlyFans and work for them so they can give them a shittier contract. Because people that are already on OnlyFans and already successful aren't going to sign with them because they're a small agency that probably doesn't actually make that much money in comparative to bigger talent management agencies for OnlyFans. And they can give them shittier contracts. Like, if your management agencies hound, this is just an example off topic of OnlyFans. Agencies hound small creators on TikTok to get them into shitty deals. Once you get bigger, the deals actually get better, like percentage-wise and shit. And just in general, like how good the management agencies that are managing you, because when you're smaller, they can take advantage of you because you know less. You're probably not going to read the contract and you're going to just sign something that fucks you over.
Do these fake little sketch advertisements.
Joe, no one gives a shit about this. If you don't care, I mean, If you don't care, you know, just a little quick million second timeout, you know, you could come back later. It's not going to be a ban, you know, but no one gives a shit about it. That's fine, man. You know, actually, no, we're going to ban you. Like, you're just being like, okay, if you don't, then leave. If you don't care. Actually, no, I'm going to unban you. You know, I'm switching my mind here. Can I ask why you did that? Okay. Now come back. You know, tell me why. Like, why are we, like, if you don't, no one gives a shit, leave the stream then. You know what I mean? Like, why are you fucking here if you're actually upset? Like, if you're sitting here bored out of your mind and you're oh, I'm just so upset. Oh, my God, just watching this video. It's so fucking annoying. Why are you here then? He put hi. Okay, are you going to say anything other than hi? Are you a little nervous? You're going to say why you said nobody gives a shit about this? It's just going to be a hi. Just hi. Hi. That's it. That's it. That's all we're saying. CL price
also
for the sub.
Seemingly aimed at women not already in the business.
Like, if you don't like it, leave. You know what I mean? Like, if you don't like the video, like, whatever. Like, just wait until the next one. Like, why are you complaining? It's pretty boring. Then peace out from the stream. See you later, man. Or just, you know, leave. Come back when this video's over. Because, you know, not... At my job as a streamer, and you're going to learn this in any stream. It's not just my stream. I don't know if you've ever chatted in any other stream before in your entire life. But if you've ever been in a Twitch stream before, you're going to realize there's more people other than you, right? And the whole goal of the stream is to entertain the audience, not the individual, right? And so when I play a video or I'm playing a game and like 95, 96% of the people are enjoying it, like, there's gonna be that 3-4% that are waiting for the next video or something. That's gonna happen, right? Like, I can't entertain every single person that's here. And so when you sit here and you tell me to, like, skip video and that you're bored out of your mind, and, like, I'm not tailoring to you, right? Remit, like, you know, I'm not... This isn't a Remit and boy stream, right? This is a stream for everybody that's here, right? And so if you don't like the video, you're not required to stay here. Fine, I'll leave. Okay, then bye. Goodbye. We'll see you later. Everybody say bye. Oh, and he left. And, oh, no, he didn't leave. He's still here. Oh, you're still here. Okay, well, free feel to stay if you want. You don't have to be here, though. You're not forced to stay here. 6 for the sub.
Yo, what's up, man?
Hey.
Where you been?
Like, you're not, like, I'm not trying to be a dick, but, like, if you come into my stream and you're a dickhead to me and you're like, I'm bored, then leave. Like, I'm not forcing you to stay here, right? Like, I'm here to entertain the people that want to be here. If you're here, I'm thankful for that. But, like, if you're going to be here and you're only going to complain, like, why are you here? I love your content, though, just this part. See, that's what I'm saying. Like, if you don't like this part, that's fine. Then just wait and... Dude, there's 4 minutes left in the video.
I got something for you.
Or you could leave, no, fucking wait, come back in 10 minutes. Like, you're not required to be here. People leave and come back all the time. Like, not every video you're gonna fucking love.
Oh, shit.
Why did it sound like he finished when she said
she was going
to the mall?
I mean, some people might, but not everybody. Hank from the
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit. Come on, Spencer, where's the professionalism? Also, for the who knows how many times I'll ask this time, why are they getting paid in all cash? In a vacuum-sealed Ziploc bag of cash, mind you. Someone investigate their business, because it looks like something else is going on here. The caption on this one reads, when she finally joined the agency. Kind of implying that if you join our agency, I mean join our family, that you could also be making 40K a month. It's so easy.
Hey, excuse me. I like your car. What do you do for a living?
I'm a model.
A model? Model for what?
Close to Look Agency.
Oh, snap. Close to Look Agency. I heard of them before, but what exactly do you do?
I work with them to grow my social media.
Social media? Influencers don't make that much money.
This is, like, entirely staged, though. Oh, my God. At least make it look somewhat less fucking fake.
Boy, this I made from last week.
Oh, my. How much is that?
40K. I gotta go.
Okay.
In this one, she just said she made 40K in the last week, and fans the cash that she left wide open, by the way, with her window down.
Lady, yeah, what a great idea. Window down, you just have a fucking 40 grand cash fucking roll right there. Arsenal for the Thringe Bet. Sorry to bring this up. Bunch of shit's going on in my life right now. I wanted to say thank you, because you're really helping me with everything that's going on. Arsenal, I'm sorry that you're going through a bunch of shit, but I'm glad that I could help.
I think you might want to find yourself an actual pimp, because that shit's getting stolen. So do their clients actually make that much money? I honestly don't know. They'll show payment receipts ranging from $1,000 to $200,000 a month. Of course, we have no way of actually knowing if those pics are from their own accounts or not, but with the whole fake penthouse thing, I'm a little skeptical. I just think it's shitty to advertise and act like anybody-
Nah, I'm not skeptical that they make money. I don't doubt that they make money. I bet that they're inflating how much they actually make.
Can make it in this business when a very small minority of OnlyFans creators make any money at all. But say they entice some woman with this proposition, then she can go to this call form where she can fill in her information, which for some reason asks her to put in her street address, and they can reach out and make the close, I guess. I like
you put in your street address before they even fucking agree to contact you?
Part of the form, which reads, who referred you to Closer Look? And you could choose from a list of dudes' names that looks like the starting lineup of the junior varsity Adirondacks Deer Hunting Club.
Quotient?
Except this one guy named Quotient? Is that a real fucking name? Yeah,
Quotient. Dude, what the fuck? Quotient? Quotient?
Yeah, I know him. He runs in the same circles as Summon Product, the boys. Anyways, you got your first client. What's next? It's time to get the word out and make some conversions, and it seems their strategy involves exploiting the boundaries of any given social platform. For instance, on TikTok, that means non-stop thirst trap posting of their different clients all over their fake verified accounts. One of them being Woman World with 9.3 million followers, another being Simp Sanctuary with 3.1 million followers, which actually at the time of recording this video, they have now deleted all their TikToks and changed their profile picture.
And at the time of recording and editing this video, the account's gone.
I guess the TikTok what? Feds were getting too close. And then here's a new one they just launched called Bunny University. I don't know exactly what
how do they keep building this many followers that fast?
Strategy is for fake TikTok verification, but I think it has something to do with the fact that this new account shows 25.4 million likes and has like 7 TikToks doing sub 10,000 views. All I know
yeah,
is Grant
that's
advertised-
fucking sauce.
Just to sell verified TikTok accounts on his Instagram for $10,000 plus. DM him. Anyways, from these TikTok accounts, they'll funnel people to their respective Instagram accounts, which funnels back to the Closer Look Instagram account, which funnels back to the Closer Look OnlyFans page, and now I see a penis. Okay, here's the Closer Look agency page. That is porn. That is immediately porn. At this point, you're gonna want to have hired virtual assistants, often dudes, who will pretend to be your OnlyFans creator, DMing other guys that subscribe to try to get more money out of them. It's predatory, borderline false advertising, and weird as hell, but it's a standard in the business. And you greedy bastard, get to hire them for just $5 an hour because they often live in very remote, poor countries. So congrats, students, you've passed my class. If you follow these steps, you too-
$5 an hour?
False advertising and weird as hell, but it's a standard in the business. And you greedy bastard, get to hire them.
See, look! Oh my God, look, this is what I'm talking about. I will be your chatter for OnlyFans. I'll manage your OnlyFans account as a chatter. They fake being the woman and flirt with the people in, like, flirt with the OnlyFans subscribers and convince them to buy, like, extra content. That's what it is.
for just $5.
I was just fucking talking about that.
$5 an hour because they often live in very remote poor countries. So congrats, students. You've passed my class. If you follow these steps, you...
That was a great video. We're going to stop it there, though, because I got to get to the next video. Because I got to dip in like 15 minutes. All right. We got to watch this last video. Banned GameStop training video. Let's get into it. Holy
gamers.
Shit, that's so fucking
loud. And welcome to the
loud.
Secret GameStop tutorial video. In this video, we'll show you how to become an honorable member of the GameStop clan. Featuring our special guest, our best employee, and MLG player of the month, Gary.
When was the last time y'all shopped at GameStop?
Yo, my name's...
Had to have been fucking, I don't know, 10 years ago for me. No, GameStop might as well be the fucking desert, dude. No one's going to that shit.
Gary the dick-faced douchebag GameStop employee. And this is my GameStop. I take my $750 job seriously as fuck. Because after 10 years of putting up with these little kids, 40-year-old mothers, and degenerates...
Alright, this was low-key a trash video so far.
Your gaming skills to the...
You work at GameStop. The purpose of your entire existence is to push buttons on a plastic-ass controller. So you must try your best to look as disgusting as possible. Take our model employee, Gary. Notice the gamer aesthetic? Just look at the absolute size of this dude. He's what you young folk might call...
Oh, this is actually cringe as fuck. Okay, this is... Who the fuck sent me this in Discord? This is a terrible video. This is actually so bad.
Talk about how we look. We're trying to play some games.
Bag body built ass boy. Just pick... Steam card. Or C. Top image. Why did I even hire you? God damn it. Alright, you beat level 1. Noob. It's time for level 2.
I'm done. Okay, we're moving on. Let's watch a small video after. Yeah, no, that one's trash. L video. Actual L fucking video. Oh my god.
Here comes a typical customer. Will you recommend...
I don't know if I could show this. We could end off with a banger, chat. Women look at their vaginas for the first time. Do you think I could watch this? What are the odds this is TOS? They don't obviously show anything. It's more so just their own commentary. What are the odds this is TOS? I'm going to say that this is TOS. I'm going to withhold on that video. Do we end on a scary video? Let's end on a scary video. We're not going to end on that. I got to do more research into that fucking video if I could actually show that. All right, we'll watch... Can we watch that one? Okay, don't peek. We'll watch don't peek. I'm going to turn off this. We'll end off with a scary video, chat. Okay. Shade for the 500 bets. Last time I was at GameStop, the Minty Fortnite pickaxe came out, if you wanted me to be honest. Dude, see, that's what I'm saying. Like, just GameStop? Ugh, I don't know. Like, I've been in there probably, like, within the past, like, 2 years, but I never buy anything. Last time I bought something was so long ago. Don't peek. Wait, should I scan it? Wait, we've seen this. This is the fucking... Okay, we've seen this one. Hold up. Oh, it's this one. Okay, now it's this one. Horror short film, An Encounter in a Public Restroom. Now we're on this one. I think this is a foreign one. Je sais juste qui vous êtes. Des feux tournent dans ma tête. Et les portes s'ouvrent de bâton. We saw that last one. We haven't seen this one. This looks like actually a good start to a movie. We've seen this. We haven't seen this one. This is a French one. Oh, shit. Now it's getting scary. Scarcore for free. Watch the Mandela catalog. I don't have time for that. I actually have to go in like 10 minutes.
Babe. Wake up. Bus pass.
Babe, wake up. Bathroom break.
Thank you.
Dude, I'm such a bitch. I'm actually such a bitch, though. Dude, I literally went like that. Oh, and I'm going to a haunted house tonight. Oh my god, I'm literally just remembering that now. That's why I'm leaving early. Holy fuck. Dude, I'm gonna be fucked. F in the chat for me. I'm gonna be so scared tonight. I hate haunted houses. Like, I actually hate haunted houses. Can you record it? I might try to record some things. Ooh.
What's wrong?
Bro's mopping the bathroom. She's old as hell. Alright, hold up. Just gonna do a double scan here, you know, just in case. Okay, we're good.
Okay, whatever.
Fuck, there's even toilet paper here. Have you had enough toilet paper?
Watch what I put in the Discord? No, I literally have to leave after this.
Yeah.
Oh, no more toilet paper? Rip.
Du papier toilette. Rouge ou bleu?
Red or blue?
Quoi?
Du papier toilette, rouge ou bleu?
Rouge, s'il vous plaît. Sorry, what the...
Alors?
I'm asking for blue. I don't know what blue is. I'm asking for blue. Red or blue? Blue. Blue.
Does color...
What does blue do? Yeah, I'm gonna go with blue.
Du papier toilette. Rouge ou bleu?
Blue. Bitch, du just say blue. Toilette. That's the only logical answer.
Rouge ou bleu?
She probably... Oh, she's probably gonna drown her. Bitch, I'm fighting that bitch. That woman was old as fuck. I'm getting up and I'm pissing. Who the fuck is that? Why did she open the door? Bitch, I would have opened the door too. That guy is ugly as fuck. Oh my god. Dude, he did not look real. Ooh, F in the chat, buddy. Buddy guessed red. Buddy guessed red. Rip. It's not TOS. I know it's not TOS. Bitch, just hit him with the sprint. Why are you getting in the car? Check behind you! Oh my god, if they're in your car. Bitch, just drive away! Stop trying to- Oh, you're dead as fuck. You're dead as fuck. It's over for you. And she was in the back seat. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Always check the back seat. Massive L.
Hello.
That is. Rip. The says real for the sub. Blue it is. That makes no sense. Why are you just choking people in the bathroom? That was a short-ass video. That was a good one, though. Hold up. All right, who do we raid, chat? That was a W stream. That went by quick as fuck. Who do we raid? T. Nichols. Who is that? Let me look. That doesn't even show up. I don't know who the fuck that is. That's it? Yeah. I've been live for 3 hours. Oh, they do show up. Never mind. I don't know what they're doing. Wait, who else is live? Let me check if somebody else is live that I don't know. Who is this?
Asked her and got it.
I accidentally fell asleep.
Do we raid them? Do we raid them, chat? It's just Ryan for the sub. We could raid. We could raid. All right, I'll raid. Chat, I will be live tomorrow at 2 p.m. EST. We are going to be doing Thief Simulator. There is a Minecraft Minecon going on, but it's at like 11 a.m. I might try to watch like a highlight of it or something, but we're probably not going to be watching that. But yeah, tomorrow is going to be Thief Sim. Sunday is going to be Reactions! Exclamation point Discord. Join the Discord and send videos for me to react to. In the video suggestion tab. Monday, I was going to do a half-sponsored stream, but it actually got moved. So Monday, I don't know what we're going to be doing yet. I'll probably talk to you guys about that tomorrow. Tuesday, I'm off. Wednesday, we're going to be playing Spider-Man Remastered. Probably might finish that game. Thursday, probably Fortnite or Val. Hope you guys had fun watching the stream. I will see you guys later. We are going to raid in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.